Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is TWiT.
Bandwidth for TWiT specials is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
This is TWiT Live Special number 261, recorded Tuesday, October 6th, 2015. Microsoft's Windows 10 devices announcement. Hello, everybody. Leo Laporte here with Mike Elgan. We're up early East Coast time. It's 10 a.m. It's, according to Microsoft, 1500 British Standard Time. All I know is it's 7 in the morning our time.
It is.
Good morning, Mike Elgan.
Good morning. Yeah, it's a good time to have an event in New York. 10 o'clock, that's not too early.
No, it's good
for New
York.
Thank you, Microsoft.
to be fair, they do it on the East and the West Coast.
Yes,
so
they
it's
do.
Not like
yes,
they limit it. But what are we expecting to see today, Mike Elgan?
Lots of hardware. We're expecting the couple of Lumias. So these should be
City Man and the Talk Man.
Yes. What's interesting about this is, of course, that every company that makes handsets is famous for its flagship. Nobody really cares about the low-end phones.
Well, nobody in the States does.
But yeah. Yes, that's right. But the reputation, it's like a car company.
Yeah,
The really hot car is the one that gives the brand its halo. And Microsoft's had this line of phones with no halo, with no brand.
It's been a long time since a flagship phone. I have a 1520, which is a couple of years old.
Yeah.
I guess you could say the Icon, the 930. Yeah. But they've been releasing all year they've been releasing inexpensive Windows phones.
Yeah.
And especially, because we want to see Windows 10 Mobile, which is still on the horizon, we'd like to see a nice high-end phone. And that's what City Man and Talk Man are.
That's right.
Also new Surface Pro 4.
It's a 4.
A new Microsoft Band, we think.
Yes. It's pretty certain that, we know they're working on the one. It's getting close. It's different from the previous one. And so that should be really interesting. And I think that, Microsoft is at a point right now where they're, once again, at a make-or-break spot for the company. They either need to establish themselves as a leader in the industry in this space, in consumer mobile and business mobile, or they're going to lose it because the competition is so brutal out there. And, of course, I think that Windows 10 Mobile, of course, it's important to their entire line of operating systems. But if it continues to be a dog, a laggard, an operating system that can garner no significant numbers of apps,
Windows 10 devices briefing.
Then they're just it's just a disaster for the company.
Here we go now to New York City. Paul Thurrott and Mary Jo Foley in the audience is our Daniel Rubino and many of our regular contributors.
They are the moments that shape our history. Great moments of
maybe one more thing too. We're
everything.
You predict HoloLens. We'll see.
Could be.
Mary Jo Foley was pretty convinced there'd be one more surprising thing to see.
You know, the company...
There's HoloLens. Yeah. All right.
The company has been very active these days in its experimental app program where they throw things out there. So they've been doing some surprising products.
Mostly for iOS. A little freeze.
Yeah.
Press play. Did you stop it? Or it's rebuffering. All right. This is an interesting time for Microsoft. Hardware's new for them, pretty much. I mean, they've done mouse and keyboards and things like that before, but the Surface Pro was their first. The Surface was their first PC, and it's actually been quite successful for them. They took a write-off on the RT, but since Surface Pro 3, I think everybody agrees this is one of the premier PCs to get.
I think it has to be said also, since this is a Microsoft hardware event.
More propaganda.
Yeah. It has to be said that Microsoft is they're actually better at hardware to a certain extent than software. If you look back at the history of their hardware, their mouse used to be, in old days, used to be the best mouse you could get.
Still is.
Xbox
I bought
is
it
awesome.
For years.
Yeah. I mean, they're really good at hardware compared to like how good Apple is at software. They're better at hardware than Apple is at software.
Software and services.
It's about you and what you can do.
Struggling a little bit, though. Certainly Windows 8 was a failure. And Windows 10, there's mixed reviews
everyone.
At this point.
Yeah.
I like it, but a lot of people have trouble
with it. Thank you for joining us in this amazing space in New York City or online via the webcast
Terry Meyerson.
Around the world.
He heads the Windows
our
team.
Engineering team back in Redmond. Thank you for joining us earlier than we've ever asked you to join us before.
Not such an Adela.
We're so honored to be here today.
Executive Vice President of Windows and Devices. So he's the guy.
Yeah.
It's hard to believe, but it's only been 10 weeks since we started rolling out Windows 10 around the world. Our team has been humbled by all of the feedback we've received. Over the last year, we've been building and shaping this product with millions of Windows insiders. It's been the best experience for all of us to work together and shape this experience.
This is a remarkable program, this public beta program.
Yeah. That 110 million devices are now running Windows 10.
And that's been a huge success for
them. Yeah, the previous number was 75 million, and that was a month after it shipped. That's pretty good.
What have these millions of people been doing with Windows 10? Well, they have viewed
easily the biggest launch of Windows ever.
Billion yes.
Most successful,
web pages
fastest.
With our new Microsoft Edge browser. People are having more fun, streaming over 120 years. 120 years of gameplay have been streamed from Xboxes to their new Windows 10
That's
devices.
Really a small number, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're exploring
so it sounds good.
Yeah. So we were just hearing from Jason that people in the HoloLens community have been invited to this event and invited
all
to
right.
watch it.
So that sounds good.
And these millions of people have not just been upgrading their current
HoloLens.
Devices. The share of Windows devices at retail has grown each month since Windows 10 has been available.
At these events, you normally don't see a panning across the audience. Did you see that camera shot? It was like panning across the back.
What do you think? Just see,
and
to show these people
weeks,
there?
Well, just to boost
these
the
millions
production
of people
values.
Have made yeah. over 1 billion
they have more than one camera this time.
To our Windows app store.
Exactly.
And developers are seeing great engagement from these
store
over
visits is a number that I probably wouldn't count.
No.
Has increased 4 times since the Windows 10 upgrade started rolling out.
I mean, I've visited the store a bunch
We're
of times. I don't think I bought anything.
Usage on Windows 10. Netflix users are now spending more time in the Netflix app than the Netflix website.
Somebody in the chat room is pointing out the applause that you're getting shows that there's a considerable number of employees in the audience.
Windows 10.
Yeah.
Journalists tend to sit
today,
on their hands, especially
we're very
for
excited
numbers
to announce
like this.
Yeah. Facebook will be building all
the
new
The recent
universal
Google event, there was, it was all journalists and nobody.
Facebook,
it was just dead silence after
Instagram,
they announced it.
And Messenger.
Facebook, Instagram, and Messenger will be available universally. That means not only on the desktop, but on the phone. And
we're
presumably Xbox.
New universal apps from Soda, for Soda
it's a big
Saga,
one. Instagram
CBS,
was very slow.
Audible, Flipagram, Uber,
Audible,
and
yeah.
many, many more. It's just been
Flipagram?
A whole.
It's
so fantastic
Flipagram.
To work with these great.
You know, the Flipagram gap is growing.
Yes.
We've also been energized by the response from IT pros. There's now over 8 million business PCs already running Windows 10.
That's actually
businesses
lower.
Around
well,
the world
no, that's,
are
that's
evaluating the security, identity, and information protection, the simplified management deployment.
That's of course, a big gap that they suffered during Windows 8. Businesses
IT
were very slow to adopt.
Security
yeah. I mean, businesses are slow
anyway,
in general.
Yeah.
It takes them a couple of years
safe.
To really, typically.
I think universally or widely anyway rejected Windows 8.
Customers are now moving faster to Windows 10 than they have ever before. On any previous release to Windows.
That's the pent-up demand. You're on 7. You're on 7. Don't want to go to 8. It's very common. This happens all the time.
Yeah.
Vista, nobody adopted in Windows 7.
Now today, this morning, we're going to start the next chapter for Windows 10 with new devices designed for Windows 10 from partners worldwide and from Microsoft. These new devices have new chips, new hardware, new capabilities like Windows Hello, Cortana, and Continuum, all made possible by Windows 10.
Continuum is an interesting feature of the new Windows Mobile.
We're incredibly excited by this device lineup.
These phones
with devices
to be desktops
designed for the best
in
entertainment, health,
dock.
Productivity. Devices designed for the workplace, for the home, for schools, or on the go. Our partners have built amazing new devices. Over the coming weeks, we'll be
should
joining
point out that
many
Eddie Q
of them
has patented
the
roll-up sleeve,
yes.
So I think Terry
lineup.
Has paid
this
a license
fee. This is the best
fee.
Device mm-hmm. lineup we've ever had for Windows from our partners.
If you go to the Microsoft front page,
morning,
it still says a devices
we're here to talk about
company.
Microsoft
you know,
devices.
Devices are very big and very important to the new Microsoft. Yep. I think that's why you saw Windows 8. They recognized that people weren't using all the Macintoshes on the back row. Oh, well. Categories. Can never get the press
like
to stop using
this. We added Xbox Live and enabled a new level of multiplayer gaming.
They can't get the sports announcers
recently,
to stop calling
like
the Windows 10 iPads.
That can replace your laptop. Like we're doing now with phones and Continuum, Surface Hub, and HoloLens.
Hub is a dark horse. That's been pushed back, but it's a very exciting product.
This holiday,
giant screen.
We've got an incredible games lineup coming to Xbox One. The greatest games lineup in Xbox history. Perhaps
in
console history. And this holiday, we'll be upgrading all Xbox Ones to Windows 10, enabling a whole new Xbox experience and bringing our Xbox gamers their number one requested feature, the ability to play their Xbox 360 games on their Xbox One.
This, I believe a beta is coming out this month with this. I don't know if it's come out yet. I haven't seen it.
And there's no better way to play all these games on new limited edition consoles that we are introducing this holiday. These consoles are inspired by this year's biggest titles.
Our producer Jason Kleanthis
like
is pointing out that the Surface was seen heavily in The Martian.
That will be available.
Yes,
big product placement.
20th,
yeah.
With 1 terabyte
Microsoft's
of
really into the product placements.
For $499. This holiday, we also have a new Elite gaming controller.
And in Narcos,
a
the
like
Nokia
no
candy bar phone, very prominent, all throughout.
Yeah. Anyone's ever
I don't think
created.
That was Microsoft paying for that.
That actually is the phone of choice for drug dealers and has been for a long time. Still is, actually.
Not only
you buy them on
your
eBay.
Xbox One, but also on your Windows 10 PC.
Don't ask me how I know that.
The burner phone of choice.
Exactly.
So now, let me preview our new TV ad for Xbox Gaming that we will launch later this week.
This is Terry Meyerson, VP
there
of Windows Devices.
Take steps.
Yep, Tomb Raider.
And those who make the great leap forward.
I remember when Lara Croft was like 12
those
pixels.
Who stay as they are. And those
and
that
Halo,
become more than they ever thought possible.
Franchise game.
They compete. And are fearless.
Odds of war, out of war, gears of war.
There are those satisfied by common pursuits.
Forza. And those for whom the extraordinary will never be
Wait
enough.
What is, whose voice is that?
So ask yourself.
Sounds like James Earl Jones.
Will you step? Or will you leap?
Interesting they should lead with this.
Yep.
Tell no new games in terms of no new franchises in there.
Yeah.
All the old franchises repeated.
Now that's what we call console class graphics.
All Thorat's excited, of course.
Xbox One is going to bring some serious fun this holiday. Now speaking of devices,
Microsoft's always liked wood paneling in their announcements. Have
Let's
you noticed that?
It's the Northeast thing, you know, it's like it's the Seattle.
It's warm, it's homey.
Yeah.
You don't see that in other tech stages.
They wear sweaters, too.
Talking
about HoloLens.
HoloLens brings experiences into our real world. Opening a window, a new
Originally
window
slated for this year, it's not going to be until next year unless they change things.
And whether next year is the developer edition.
Right.
And so the consumer edition is years
entertainment,
off.
HoloLens creates innovative experiences
this
that are simply
Microsoft's
not possible
reality
on any
visor.
Other device. Or any
with
other
a built-in
platform.
PC, and that's what's really interesting and probably really
As you've
challenging
seen all year,
for them.
Yeah. We've been so fortunate to work with great partners across many industries. But today, we wanted to try something a little different and show you something we've been developing internally and playing at home with our families. It's an exploration in mixed reality entertainment.
Mixed reality
made possible
is interesting
by HoloLens. Let's take a look.
It's got to be Minecraft, right? Unless he's building a jet engine.
The whole family can build a jet engine.
Terry Meyerson leaving the stage and a young, hip person with a faux hawk entering.
Thanks, Terry. Today, we're excited to show you mixed reality gaming on HoloLens. Specifically, how HoloLens can turn every room of your house
the gaming
to
is
a
taking
personalized
the lead.
Video game level. There's now, to do that, we're going to be showing you a game codenamed Project X-Ray. We also have this custom camera that can see a full view of every hologram. Dan sees all the holograms he's looking at, but this camera will show you all of the action on stage. Now, Project X-Ray is a game that can be played in any room.
This has been deceptive in the past, implying that you have a broader range of vision than you actually have in the demos. But we're going to have to wait till Paul and Mary Jo come back to find out what you can actually see.
Amazing holograms in your world, and how those holograms can interact with the environment.
I'm glad they picked somebody who actually looks like a gamer.
Yeah.
We want to take mixed reality one step further. So we've got something new to show you. Holograms you can hold.
Holograms you can hold.
Ooh. There we go. So what's happening is that his fist is being taken over by this, like, you know, space weapon type of thing all around.
Yeah, this is completely deceptive because that's not what you're going to see.
This is a wearable hologram. And when you combine technology like this with the environment understanding of HoloLens, you can do some pretty spectacular things.
Hologram seems to be Microsoft's word for mixed reality.
Yeah.
Nice.
So then he used the space weapon to blow fake holes in a fake wood panel.
It's a real wood panel, but the holes are fake.
Yeah.
And whatever that is, I'd get the hell out of there.
Yeah.
This looks fun. But again, I think it's so deceptive because we're seeing a full field of view. Untethered,
which means Dan is free to move
and Dan is looking through a mailbox, a mail slot, unless they've really improved this thing.
Smoke and mirrors or not, this is a mind-blowing demo right here. This looks really good.
It does look like
fun. And thanks to spatial sound, you'll hear the gameplay as though it's happening in your room.
Did you say fear?
You'll notice that the robots know where the walls and the furniture are.
That's
and they
interesting.
Can use that knowledge to navigate
that
and
would
plan
be fun,
attacks
wouldn't it?
Against
yeah.
you.
Robots
Since
invading
each room
your
is
house.
Unique, every game is customized to you.
This is actually terrifying at this point.
The experience of what they're showing right now, where you see the living room, but then the robots and the scorpions and stuff are all like appear to be crawling around in your own house, that is the future of gaming right there. That's going to be huge.
Yeah. Remember Microsoft showed off
holograms behave
something similar
just
with
like
projectors.
Real objects. They can interact with the environment and with each other.
I can't remember what they called it.
It was called Illumiroom.
Illumiroom, that's right.
And that was a patented process that we haven't seen in an actual product yet.
For larger enemies with more powerful weapons, Dan can even use his shield to defend himself.
Wow, that's cool. So he's got this virtual shield that, of course, isn't there.
This would be awesome fun. A little bit, perhaps, damaging for the living room.
Nicely done.
Right, just when you like take off the goggles and realize the holes are real.
I've destroyed them. Well, I'm thinking of the furniture jumping around. And
We hope you enjoyed
I would really
Project
like. We'll have to see what that looks like.
Mixed reality.
That was literally the coolest demo Microsoft has ever done on stage.
Because with mixed reality entertainment, you never
it's
know
the holodeck.
What's around the corner.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. What's behind you? Look behind you. He's scared now. No more. Let's blow some more holes in the wall. Oh, that's terrifying. Oh, jeez. I would really like to see what he's seeing instead of...
Yeah.
Let's be projected. Project X-Ray. Terry Meyerson coming back.
That's just so cool.
They also trotted out the phrase, wearable hologram.
The only device that mixes holograms into our world, opening up these entirely new computing experiences. HoloLens is packed with space-age technology, see-through HD holographic lenses.
And take care of your health, kids. This won't be a while before this comes out.
Map your environment and understand your movements. And custom-built silicon, the world's first holographic processing unit. And even with all of this technology, HoloLens is fully untethered.
Yeah, that's
no
that's what's
wires,
remarkable about this.
No phones.
The entire computer's
no
in the
connection to
visor.
A PC required.
Probably also what's so challenging about it.
Yeah.
And now is the time when we want to unlock the creativity of Windows developers worldwide.
They're going to offer a HoloLens
today,
development kit.
We are taking applications for the HoloLens development kit.
Taking applications.
Which will be available
How much?
In the first quarter of 2016 for $3,000.
$3,000.
That's a little more tepid applause for that one.
It has been so exciting to work with partners in so many industries. NASA, Autodesk, Case Western Reserve University. We've seen so many amazing experiences.
I do think this could be the and it's interesting they're showing gaming because it could also be the future of interfaces for desktop.
And now,
computing.
I just can't wait to see what
the applications
Windows developers are going to do
quite broad.
With holographic computing.
It's exactly what Oculus said during their announcement. We can't wait to see what you do.
Yeah.
Let's talk about another part of our lives.
But of course, the timing of this
Microsoft
is to compete
devices
with Oculus
can have
the
a
Rift
meaningful impact.
Release.
We designed the Microsoft Band to help people take control of their health and fitness in a more personalized way, from seasoned athletes to people who are renewing their commitment to fitness. Here is the new Microsoft Band.
Mostly for people renewing their fitness commitments.
Yeah.
As one of those folks. Paul loves his band.
Yeah.
The rumor was it would be curved around the wrist, and that looks like it is.
They're there to be pushed.
Looks a lot like the renders we've seen.
Challenged.
The band was a surprise hit for Microsoft. I think that they released it not expecting a lot and actually got a lot of attention.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Cortana's built in, it looks like.
Look at in the rearview mirror while you move forward.
Yeah, they've really updated this thing. Dictation.
So live with nothing standing in your way.
This is an interesting product.
Introducing
this is becoming more like the
Microsoft
Apple Watch.
Band. Yeah. For people who want to live healthier and achieve more.
They're focusing on the fitness angle.
With Microsoft Band, there are no limits to what you can do. So do great things.
The golf course map was interesting. Myerson snuck off during that.
I'm so excited to tell you about the new Microsoft Band.
Lindsay Matisse.
And I'm on the Microsoft Band and Microsoft Health team. I love my band. It goes everywhere I go. I run, hike, cycle, and most importantly, I train with it.
Microsoft Health team.
Over the course of the past 10 years, I've spent most of my free time running marathons and finishing a couple half Ironman triathlons along the way. But don't get me wrong, I am solidly a middle of the pack athlete. But now that I live in the Pacific Northwest, I am earning my street cred by training for my first ultra marathon.
Oy.
And the Microsoft Band has totally optimized my training.
She's wearing a regular
wristwatch
as well.
I can systematically achieve so much more than a personal record. I can achieve my personal best, and you can too, wherever you are on your health journey. Since the Microsoft Band launched last year,
the Microsoft Band looks kind of like what people thought the Apple, the iWatch would look like. Remember that?
Yeah. We've provided great feedback on functionality, hardware, and partnerships. And we took that feedback along with our own midday team runs, Friday fitness workouts, and Microsoft Research, scenario-based ideation. Hey, what would cyclists, golfers, and gym rats want? We kept grinding to push the product.
Yeah, they're really
innovate,
pushing this as a fitness product.
For you.
Yeah.
Now,
but it seems
I just want
to
share some of my personal favorite things about the band. First, the design. When we set out to create this version, we had a couple of design principles. Optimize for the individual who goes to work and enjoys working out, like me. Make it breathable and flexible. No rigidity in any directions, no uncomfortable shoulders, no hard edges, and above all, it must curve nicely around the wrist.
And that is an improvement.
Yeah, awesome.
The previous band was pretty much a flat lozenge.
We figured out a way to optimize the screen size and redesign the screen itself so it curves. Plus, with the Gorilla Glass, the organic LED screen is scratch-resistant and optimized to be more responsive to touch.
It's interesting. They're not really going after the jewelry look. They're not.
No. Right on.
They're just accepting the fact, and I think probably wisely, it's going to look like a device on your wrist. It's not.
So that means you've got your onboard GPS
sleep tracking, calorie tracking,
UV
smart notifications,
guided workouts,
UV.
You can track your sleep and your calories.
Built-in GPS.
You can also
that's
set
very good.
Yeah. Customizable notifications for your calls.
Text, somewhat standalone
emails, and social updates.
runners want that GPS. Oh, we lost the audio.
Cortana integration.
Yeah, so Cortana, that's huge.
So let's say you miss a workout. Cortana will offer to reschedule it for you. It'll keep you updated on your calorie expenditure throughout the day with a constantly updated
certainly
graph.
Is going to mean it's got to be connected to a phone.
But our customers asked for something specific, a way to track elevation. I get it. Huh? I love spending time in the mountains.
Question is, which type of phone?
So we added an 11th sensor.
Do you need a barometer?
I would expect you wouldn't, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Barometer.
Huh.
Now you can track your fitness with even more precision by measuring elevation changes in real time. Great for hiking, biking, or just climbing stairs. Now, this is truly awesome work to be contributing to for me personally.
Current band already does UV according to
Rex Cardan. Our research shows as customers are using the band, they're burning more calories. They're using the band to track their run and they're running longer distances. They're increasing their workout times and they're analyzing their sleep patterns to maximize their rest between workouts. The band is providing information that is usable.
You wear it while you're sleeping. When do you charge it?
It doesn't matter if you're a
usable
serious athlete
crunchable.
Halfway through an amazing career, or if you just want to understand your sleep, track it, and jog around the neighborhood for the first time.
It's for the data. It's quantified
now,
itself. The
I have
data.
I've been using the new band during my recent marathon training.
Athlete.
And like a lot of runners, I can get really into my data. With the Microsoft band, I have constant and immediate access to big data. My own big data. My every run. My every step, my every workout, and my every night of sleep.
Jokes about my own big data.
With Microsoft Health,
I like
which
big
powers
data.
The band, I can dig right into that stuff as soon as I've finished a run or an exercise.
Who's your data?
This makes it usable data that can help me optimize more than my workout, but my post-workout rest. As you can see from the details of my recent run, I understand
it's
low,
abuse of the
peak,
big data
and average
concept.
Heart rate. Using the
because that's really about
monitor,
millions of people
band.
And
small data.
I understand how my calorie burn breaks out in carbs
data.
Versus fats and properly refuel after a run. I also have insight on my recovery as detailed in my cardio benefit. Only the Microsoft band does this.
But I think it's not
awesome.
Monitoring your calories. You're going to be doing some data entry
One
there.
One of the most important measurable components of fitness is VO2 max, which is simply the maximum amount of oxygen your body can process in 1 minute.
That's a hard thing
so
to measure.
So women my age can hit about 40 or 50 with solid training.
And a very valuable
Now compare that to endurance cyclists who can hit about 80 or 90, which is insanely amazing.
It's basically oxygen.
But what was once a trip for hardcore athletes to a serious training center and a bunch of straps attached to your face, hopping on a treadmill, is now available on your wrist. As the band tracks heartbeat plus our algorithm,
this
we
looks
can
a lot like the
your maximum volume of oxygen.
Apple lab for the watch that they showed before they released
that,
it
that image
with people running in VO2 max,
when
and
I
they
say
never, of course, released
only
that capability.
Only the Microsoft band does this. That's amazing.
How does it measure VO2 max?
There's a little needle that goes
now,
into your
wrist. We're committed to delivering tech-powered insights for
Very
everyday athletes, no matter the sport you play, and that includes golf. And while I'm still punishing myself by trying to learn
That's
the game, the band is truly helping me. First of all, it provides unprecedented automatic shot detection. So that means it knows whether I'm putting,
That's
if I'm
pretty
driving
impressive.
The ball, if I'm taking practice swings, and it doesn't count my practice swings. This is all delivered based on our built-in gyroscope, accelerometer, and vibration sensors. When I walk up to the tee box, it actually knows what tee I'm at, the distance to the green, the calories I've spent, and my heart rate. It's like having your own virtual golf caddy.
The Garmin Forerunner does VO2
and
max
when my
estimates.
Complete, I get an automatic scorecard.
Very popular
Only
running
the
watch.
Microsoft band
but it's an estimate.
Does all
it's
of
not.
This.
It can't measure it.
The new Microsoft Band is the only wearable device that offers this kind of deep
well.
Functionality across iOS, Android, and importantly, Windows
the
devices.
The golf market is actually potentially
Microsoft
huge.
Microsoft Health is now a Windows app that works across your phone and PC, providing you all of this data wherever you are, on the green, on a bike. It's amazing. But we know our customers have partnerships and relationships and communities of data outside of Microsoft Health and Microsoft Band. So throughout the last year, we have worked to bring in these new partners, as you can see, an amazing list. And we're ensuring these experiences are wrist optimized. So if you want to use Uber, you're just one touch away. If you want to do a guided workout with Gold's Gym, you're just one touch away.
Interesting. So apps.
If you want to stay connected via Facebook, one touch away.
Uber.
Today we're thrilled to announce another new partner.
This is really interesting.
Lose It is one of the top nutrition trackers in the world.
Yeah, I love Lose It.
With one glance at your Microsoft Band, you know how many calories you've burnt, how many you have left to consume, and how many steps you'll need to take before you grab another latte on your way out today. And what's truly exciting is you won't have to wait long to get a new Microsoft Band. You can pre-order the Band later today, and it will be available beginning October 30th and will retail for $249.
Nice price. Very good price. That's at the low, $100 below the cheapest Apple Watch, and at the low end even for
the Microsoft Band
Android
is ready
Wear.
To be a big part of your health
It's more expensive
story.
Than a Surge or
it's
you know,
your
the
coach
other Fitbits.
To get you to the start line.
If they're smart, and they're not, they would give every person in that room one.
Yeah.
It's your That's personal assistant who helps yeah. you stay on top
They'd
of day-to-day
have all the journalists
life
wearing
and work.
Right.
No matter your sport,
Fitbit Surge
no
is the same price.
Story,
it's like $250. So
the Microsoft
it's
Band
comparable
is here to
a Surge.
Live healthier. And
I wish
more.
She'd said something about Thank what you. Hardware it works with. Does it require a Microsoft phone?
Yeah.
It'd be great if they said works with iOS and Android. I'd
Thank
love
you,
to
Lindsay.
See that.
Now,
and we're still working on our Windows
about
10.
Devices that we designed
Just kidding.
Yeah. To make people
iOS,
more
Android,
productive
and Windows 10.
It says that?
Before.
They said they said it earlier.
Let's talk about Surface
okay.
and Lumia.
Surface and Lumia. All right.
Surface is the iconic Microsoft device for people who want to be productive.
They're moving quite a brisk pace here.
Tablet
Half an hour in, and they've already announced.
Laptop.
Yeah, they're learning.
Yeah.
In just 3 years, Surface has grown from a $0 business for Microsoft to over $3.5 billion a year. Now, both Dell and HP are reselling Surface to their business customers. And the entire Windows ecosystem has embraced this category, which Surface created of two-in-ones, with sales more than doubling in the last year.
I think Intel might dispute that Microsoft created the two-in-one.
Yeah.
We see
our
opportunity
Lenovo.
With Lumia like we once looked at the opportunity
They should take
with
a victory
Surface
lap at Apple
to reinvent the
new
category
iPad Pro
and
yeah.
make people more productive
They've been validated
in new ways.
Yes. by both Google and Apple.
And customers
they
are responding.
The Google Pixel C, the iPad Pro.
In the
Pro.
Last year, almost 1,000 new businesses have chosen Lumia to help them be more productive. So now let's hear
what?
From the person who we've
no
recently
applause?
Chosen to lead the entire Microsoft device family. Please welcome Panos Panay to share some more news with you.
Is a Surface VP.
Wow.
Guy in charge of Surface.
That was kind of cool. Welcome. It's great to see you. It's great to see you. Terry, thank you, man. I'm unbelievably excited to be here today. We got a lot to talk about. What did you guys think of that Holo demo? Was that killer? Oh my God. It blew
this guy's
me away. When I saw
really
it,
trying
it
to keep it real.
Away. Can you imagine what we're doing? Do you know how blessed I feel to lead devices for Microsoft right now? The opportunities, all the things we're bringing together, everything we're bringing together, what Windows 10 is doing right now to thread it all perfectly together, it's mind-blowing. When you see it, just look a little further, just look a little deeper. It's happening right now. Now, I've been doing it a short time, and I gotta tell you, I'm excited about what I'm seeing, but let me just start talking to you a little bit about Lumia. Can I tell you about the new phones really quick?
So City we're gonna man, do. Talk man, let's see.
First off, this team, I've been working with them for a very short time, but I gotta tell you, the passion, the creativity, the desire to bring you the most productive products possible.
And they got promoted a couple months ago
it's
to
unmatched.
Be in charge of all the high-end
I'm so inspired by this
devices,
team. And you just think about what they're doing. They're building the best
premium
products for
devices.
Windows that can possibly be made for Windows 10. And think about Windows 10. There are 110 million, did you hear that? 110 million devices in 8 weeks running Windows 10. Did anybody hear it? Think about what that means for the phone. The power of Windows security, the power of the Windows update, keeping you fresh all the time. That same consistent UI from Windows 10 on your PC, on your Surface, to your phone.
I'm unpersuaded by that. I don't think it does mean anything significant for the phone.
Think about what comes across.
Is it? I mean,
Cortana, well, it's up to developers.
A billion questions
you know, for instance,
think about one that's in your pocket.
We're using it, interested because we could develop one XAML-based app that would cross all the platforms.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a good thing for us as
the best Outlook client you can find anywhere.
And it's kind of a recognition that nobody's going to develop standalone for the phone at this point. It's too small a market.
Yeah.
But what is it? Who brings it to life? What does it come with? Let me introduce you to the Lumia 950 family.
Lumia 950 family.
Two phones.
I'm going to talk to you about the phone, but before we jump in too far, I want to talk about the hardware just a little bit. Just
the
give
icon
you a little
was a 930.
Of what's happening, the technology, and what this team, what this Lumia team has put together, which I think is pretty powerful, and for me has been super powerful. Let's start with the antennas and always being connected. It's a principle of mine. I want to share it with you. Kind of want you to feel it. And we're just getting started here, but these antennas, these are generations in the making.
This guy's good, I got to say.
Okay, there are two antennas in this product, but why? Why?
Why?
Why two? Who puts two?
Why, Panos? Why?
And they are vast, and they are some of the best on the planet. It's like, literally, it's this whole thing of pushing more than one phone in a phone. Because when you hold it, when you're holding your phone up like you're doing right now, no matter where you're holding it, we will choose for you to give you the best connection you could possibly have.
Adaptive antennas have been around for years.
What a phone is. Staying connected, and that's what that does. It's a great tech.
Yeah.
On top of that, that's cool.
Can't hold it wrong. But, frankly, not unusual.
That was totally for the geeks in the room, by the way. I'm so glad you appreciate it, man, because I love that. All right. We also have the octa-core and hex-core processors. I have two phones to introduce you to today. We have the 950, which uses the hexa-core processor, and the 950 XL, which uses the octa-core. We use the latest Qualcomm technology, and we push that technology to every limit possible. We push it by using tablet-class liquid cooling, literally
liquid
coming
cooling
from our Surface team into our phones, because what we wanted was to push these machines as hard as we possibly could, because we want to make them as productive as possible, because we want to bring Windows 10 to life in your pocket. That's the whole goal. And that's what the Lumia team has done. It is just phenomenal technology. The phones come with a 5.2-inch and a 5.7-inch screen. They're absolutely beautiful organic LEDs. Yep, they're gorgeous. These things
are
500
dpi. Same form factors that Google chose for its Nexus.
It's super soft. You'll never see a pixel. This is all simple. You know this. You know it because I saw you write about it already, so I'm just blowing through. I know, which was terrible, by the way. Can you not do that next time? Ruins my moment.
Acknowledging that the rumor
what I love
got it
about
all
LED,
right.
I'm going to just share with you. Look, I'm always moving. I'm moving fast, and my children are at home watching. But I will tell you, one of my big things in life is to be more present when I'm at home, be more present with my team when we're sitting around making a phone or a Surface. Like, this is a big deal for me. Well, here's something that Windows 10 has done and has lit me up and has helped me so much. When you pull your phone out of your pocket, you can't see this because it's so dim, but you pull your phone out of the pocket, you don't have to push a button, you don't have to do anything. I get so much information in the glance screen technology. Let me relate this to the OLED screen. We can light up the pixels we want to light up. And now I have a picture of my kids. I know what my next meeting is.
Samsung's known this for a while. Motorola as well.
So is Microsoft.
I also know how many mails I have, how many texts I have, what time is it, what date is it. I didn't
touch anything.
Microsoft
Glance has
been
around.
By the way, I'm using zero battery life while I stand here.
But this is out of the Apple playbook to really emphasize all these things, whether they're new or not.
Now, granted, it's not the best thing to say, hey, I'm super present by glancing and putting away, but it's a lot better than me turning on my phone, logging in, finding what I wanted to find. I mean, it keeps me there. It's so important. Now, being present and being connected with your family, that's a big deal, right? Would you guys agree? Somebody in here has a family, right? You agree with that? Yeah, super important to me. I think you're going to feel that with all our products today. But here's what I'll tell you. There's probably nothing more important on the phone.
How to
right
use your
than
phone and still be present
be
with your family.
Yes. Full power and performance, yes.
And your team. Don't forget your team.
And your team. Got to be present with
think
your team.
Think about the Lumia 1020 that came out and started to change
triple
the
LED because Apple has two 20 megapixel sensors.
You probably have
that's
a
nice
product in your pocket right
OIS
now that has a great camera on it. But I will tell you, all the generations of work that have come into the camera on these new products will blow your mind. It's got a 20 megapixel sensor, which is just beautiful. It's unbelievable in low light. So if you're taking a picture in low light, you will get the full sensor, the full camera, the full picture you want. If you wanted to use the flash, we have a triple RGB flash off the back of the product. What does that mean? I know in words. Here's what it means. When you take a picture, there's no red eye. Here's what it means. When you take a picture, you don't look like a
this
ghost.
This guy's definitely a coffee
you
achiever.
You look like a human.
Yeah.
You get the true color coming off. In the product, we have an optical image stabilizer. This is a really cool part of the technology. It's five generations in the making. This is the part where I look at it and go, oh, I'm so inspired. I'm so pumped for what we can do.
Dedicated camera button always has been an important feature and has been left out of some Lumias, so it's nice to see that back.
I cannot take a picture to save my life. Every time I take one, it's blurry. You take a picture
keeping
with
the PureView brand as well.
I don't care if the image is moving or I'm moving. It's going to be clear. It is absolutely a gorgeous, gorgeous camera. Now I'm going to talk to you.
Camera's really been the strength of Lumia phones. I'm glad they're paying attention to that.
Smallest little feature on a product.
Yeah, there was a little while there where people would say, oh, the Apple so-and-so is the best camera. No, actually, it's the Nokia.
Right.
For a while. You know we believe in this.
No, PureView is a Nokia brand. It's been around since for ages.
I just, as a kid growing up, every camera I picked up, do you know how I took a picture?
808.
I used to push a button.
1020.
I know times are changing, and you can take a picture touching your screens. Do that all day. But I used to push a button, this button.
Yeah.
I'd push it.
And in the renders we saw, the leaks we saw didn't have that button.
Yeah. I'm taking you in 4K video right now, as it turns out. So
4K video.
Moment you had.
Yeah, that's good, too.
Check it out. Now I'm taking me, which is...
This really responds to people who said, where is Microsoft's flagship?
This is it, obviously. I just push a button, take it out of my pocket. I know it's small. Man, it's super powerful. But you know what else just happened? All that information just went to the cloud. I have it forever. It's awesome. This phone has 32 gigs. If you wanted to store it,
he means
storage.
Microsoft.
You know what else Windows 10 allows you to do?
32 gigs is not a lot of storage.
You know what these phones let you do? They let you do
SD
that.
SD card?
You can put right now, just get an SD card, put it in there, 256 gigs, and boom, you have all that memory for your files, for your pictures. And theoretically, when the hard drives catch up, you could push this thing to a full 2 terabytes in my pocket. 2 terabytes, is that ridiculous?
Ridiculous.
Let's talk a little bit more about something that is a bit funny to talk about. I'm talking about the connector on the bottom of this product because it makes a few points. Let me just do that really quick. There's a USB Type-C connector.
Type-C
connector on the bottom of this product.
The Type-C momentum USB-C. Continues to build.
It's a pretty cool connector. Yeah. It allows us to push 5 gigabits per second.
So they're using the 3.1 spec too,
super
which is
fast.
Good.
Here's the first thing it does for you. If you burn your phone for 2 days, I bet a lot of you do, and you didn't have time to charge, or you went to bed
charging.
And you didn't know, and you got 1,000 mails, or you let it burn, and you woke up and you're like, man, I'm almost out of battery, my day's got to start, plug in this charger, literally, in less than 30 minutes, you get more than 50% charge and get yourself out of the house and get moving.
I wonder what chip they're using in there. If it's a Microsoft
I know, they're fundamental, but man,
ARM chip, or if
this
they're actually
things up for you.
Using the 810, the Snapdragon.
Now, what's the point? You got all this processing power. We're using tablet-class liquid cooling to cool these things. You got full Windows 10. It's coming to the phone. We have Office, Cortana. You have Skype. You have OneDrive. Your settings are carrying over. Edge is coming to life.
Wore off.
You have the best mail client on the planet. This is supposed to be the most productive phone you've ever picked up, but what does that mean? Why do we push it? Why the octa-core? Why push it so
because
far?
Because everybody else has octa-core.
Here's why.
That's
we
why
want to
we
put Windows
it.
In your pocket. 110 million people using Windows 10 right now. If you haven't thought about these phones, wake up. Spend a minute. With the universal apps coming, 110 million in 8 weeks, the opportunity is unbelievable.
Yeah, I really like that.
The best
number.
Way to see that,
yeah, that's
and probably the most fun way to
success.
See it, is to see how Continuum
point
really does bring the
years.
PC from the phone. I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Brian Roper to show you what that means. Brian.
Okay. This is the Red Bull of phones, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Panos.
Here's the Continuum. This is really interesting.
How y'all doing this morning?
Oh, he's back, baby.
He's back. His hat is, the hat is back.
Awesome.
Get ready for an infomercial, folks.
Phone?
I love this guy.
Are you ready to see the phone now?
I actually
enjoyed
it. All
right, now check it out. I'm going to jump right in. I have a lot to cover. So the first thing I want to start with is what you would probably start out doing on your phone first. That's unlocking it, signing into it. You've probably likely heard of Windows Hello.
His hat is even funkier now. It's got a rakish angle
to it,
isn't
it? Recently. It's that personal fun experience. I mean, for me, who has an Xbox right now? Make some
noise. I do. I have an Xbox.
Yeah?
Yeah, I make some noise.
It blew my mind and made me smile the first time I stood in front of my Kinect.
It made me smile.
I smiled and said, hey, Brian. I was like, oh, well, me? That was great.
Hey, Brian.
When I saw that on PC, it lit up. And we're bringing that in beta to Windows Phone. So I'm going to show you Windows Hello beta now running on a phone. Very simple experience.
This guy has a sweater.
I'm going to show you that unlock experience now. When I pick up this phone, it's going to look for me.
Brian the Hat Duckworth.
Hey, Brian.
No.
And just like that, it unlocks. It was that fast. What do you think about that?
Whoa.
I know.
Yeah.
We're going to jump right in. Now, I want to walk you through just a couple things in the UI now. Looks like we're going to get that up. Now, here we go. Okay, so now, pay attention to my live tiles here. Pay attention to this menu, because I'm going to anchor you to this in a second.
There's hey, finally, Mac, two cameras.
Birthday, Office Mobile,
see, it can be
included
done.
With Windows Phone, you know, universal apps that are going to scale and look great. Just take a look at that and take it in, because I'm going to call back to this in a second here. I have a text message that I just noticed I got. This is a guy named Todd. He's like, Brian, you're traveling, but you owe me a deck. You got to do some stuff. You know it's bad in the work world when they start texting you. It probably means you missed a bunch of mail in the box. They're mad at you. So I got to get some stuff done. This is a point where I need some PC-like productivity. Okay? And with Continuum for Phone, I'm empowered to have that. I'm empowered to,
the question
to really
is, do you carry this
use my
around
phone
with
like
you?
A PC.
I mean,
but how does that work? How do I do that?
Maybe you do.
Okay, I'm going to show you. Right now, I'm going to hold this up for you. This is the Microsoft Display Dock. Okay, this dock will enable me to connect my phone via that USB Type-C connection right there, and utilize a large monitor, keyboard, and mouse with these
USB-C.
Little nice ports. Okay, to get a PC-like experience. Now, for the sake of the demo, just to save some time, I've already set one up here and plugged it into this monitor, keyboard, and mouse. So that's what's going on here. But let's take a look at that experience now. Okay, what you're seeing looks like a Windows 10 desktop, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Sounds like one.
You might even be thinking, Brian, maybe
watch
you're tricking
language,
me with
Brian.
Some demo magic. Maybe that's not really your phone. This is my phone.
And this is one advantage, and up here you can see this my out before Microsoft has with this one Windows, is that even though it isn't really a Windows PC, it looks the same, and you'll feel comfortable.
These right here are my live tiles from the phone that I showed you earlier. Remember
it's
that?
Not live tiles,
remember
it's
my
lab
little
tiles.
Son Max, remember Office? This is my phone start menu because this is my phone. I'm going to keep hammering that back on you. This is my phone pushing this experience. All right?
I love
so
this
now,
guy.
Remember, Todd told me I had a mail to open. I'm going to open up this mail app now and actually click. Oh my gosh, y'all are blowing up Twitter. I forgot that my demo account is my Twitter handle. That was bad. Let me scroll down there. Cool. Here's my mail from Todd. And you can see I have a couple documents here. What I'm going to do now is just open up some stuff to get ready to get productive. I'm going to open up Word with a double click because there's something in there I got to get to do. And now, once that loads, remember, this is the Word Universal mobile app, Word Mobile. It's now scaling. This is the one that comes on the phone. It's scaling to look great on this screen. And look, all the functionality you expect is there. The welcome back message is there with one click. It takes me to where I was in this document last, right? And I want to go back and open some other stuff. So how do I multitask? More PC-like experience. Look down here. My taskbar has my icons like you'd expect. The one that's running is highlighted like you would expect. With one click on Outlook, I can jump to that app and utilize it like you would expect on a PC, except this is actually a what? It's a phone. That's right. So I'll double click PowerPoint now to open that up because I'm getting my stuff
ready. I got to start doing the touch your ear.
What?
What is it?
It's a what?
This, so it must be super important. And right now, I just want to pause.
So he's doing PowerPoint.
I showed you the taskbar, but look, I can bring up this task switcher. And also bring that up.
Wow.
Who's used this task switcher on Windows 10 right now?
Yeah.
When Panos Panay was killing it on stage, he was backstage going, I'm gonna dazzle him.
Give me another cup of that Red Bull.
Show you with the copy and pasting. Just to prove to you that my phone is powering
Panos
this,
we're gonna
cut
wings.
Now to a side-by-side. I'm gonna show you, while I'm doing this, my phone is still a phone. You can see up here I'm connected to my monitor. But look, I can go back to my start menu, I can navigate things, I could open up and start texting people. My actual phone experience is not broken while I'm utilizing the desktop experience of Continuum, and neither is the one here.
Kidding aside, this is really the future. A lot of people are going to be doing this kind of
thing. Yeah, it's great. Right, I mean, the Atrix attempted to do
now,
this.
While I have this open side by side, I want to show you something
device.
Kind of cool. I talked about the power of these
Samsung
universal apps,
device,
how
but,
they can scale to screen
nobody wanted to do it.
Right here on my monitor, the phone is pushing
this is what
the
Type
Outlook
C gives you,
app, right?
That Type C
watch
connector.
Watch this. I'm going to open it on the phone, and you're actually going to see it
bi-directional
and
high
scale
speed
down to the phone. That's the power of a universal app in action. This app does not care what
I'm
screen size
I'm surprised Google
is.
Didn't talk
just
about this
in real time
on its
looks great.
New Nexuses, which also feature Type C.
Yeah. But now,
they really didn't highlight any of the benefits. They said, here's this, here's that. There was no touching their ear.
Because I have to put a table in the middle of this deck. That's what the mail said. So look at this. Here's Word. I want to put this table there. Guess what? I can select it, and even though my phone is powering this, I can use all the keyboard shortcuts I'm familiar with. So
yeah,
actually,
I think you're right. I think
this is a
breakthrough moment
sure
for mobile technology.
There. I actually am going to do old controls.
I think what really started it is the big screens, because people started using the big screens for real work.
PowerPoint.
Right.
And now, now that we're doing that, let's do it on a really big screen.
And I'll just go ahead and do Control V to paste that table. I am
you,
not fitting
but where
the purple,
do you use this?
Even
you,
I'm
you, bring,
it,
you
so
can't bring a monitor on the road with you. You probably don't want
to
bring a keyboard.
Slate there. there and get the rich formatted.
You do this,
the
you bring, but you dock the phone at work?
What you do is you have one at home or work, but then when you're not there, you use the phone to do the exact same stuff.
Right. So it's all still there.
How can we possibly make this more like a PC? There's one little way.
Okay,
I love
death?
The cloud. I use the cloud all the time. It's important to me. But I'm paranoid sometimes. I don't know about you. I'm always worried that I'm going to get an email from old Todd or somebody when I'm away from internet or away from a way to connect, right? So a lot of folks like me still, just as a backup, maybe carry USB drives, maybe
this.
Like to expand memory in their phone like Panos talked about. We want to have our stuff with us. So what's really awesome is this Microsoft Display Dock allows me to connect USB and removable media to it and utilize it with this desktop-like experience. And check this out. I'll just go to Insert and a Picture. And now it defaults to the Photo app because I did choose Pictures. But look, I can choose a location, and there's my Lexar thumb drive. Just like that, I can choose that drive, come in, and by the way, I can hold Control to select the stuff that I want to, or Shift, and I can bring in these graphics. Now check it out. These are fully transparent PNGs that I just brought in from a thumb drive powered by my phone into PowerPoint that looks like a desktop because I can be productive like a
boss.
Well,
laissez les bon temps rouler, man.
You know what he looks like with that hat? He looks like a comedian on one of the Spanish language shows.
I'm glad you're excited. I don't want to just talk about work, though, because we like to play, too. We play on the phones. This is an amazing device for entertainment consumption. You want to watch your videos? You want to stream stuff? This is awesome. Number one, of course, you can connect to modern monitors wirelessly.
Joe Belfiore just tweeted, the most amazing thing is your fingers just do what they want to do.
What I really want to call out here is the fact
I'm doing it right now.
I don't know what they got backstage.
The display docks means I'm getting full HDMI out of the back of this. That means I have full 1080p video. That means I have full, robust, ground-shaking audio coming out of that. And just to prove it to you, what I'm going to do is go over here and play this Jurassic World trailer. Listen to this.
Again, you'd have to carry fairly large speakers with you in your man purse.
Yeah.
It's a relationship.
I'm going to go ahead and stop that trailer now. I'll click to stop that. Oh. Did you hear that? That's
yeah,
insane.
Well.
That's coming from a phone, folks. If you want to be productive at the top level, if you
there's
want
really
to consume entertainment at the top level,
revolutionary about amplifying sound from a phone and having it be loud.
Windows is enabling these experiences I'm showing you right now.
You
for can, continuing
you've
for
been able to do that for
HDMI
a decade from
dock.
Any phone.
Folks, did you like what you saw today?
I want you to line up in the back.
I'm Brian Panos. I'm done, brother. Where you at, Pete? Come on back. Thank you, folks. That's my time.
He was really great at IFA. Unfortunately, the demo was marred by the fact that they wouldn't show what he was demoing, but he's shown his stuff here today.
The 950 and the 950 XL.
I'm not clear on what the differences are besides screen size and the number of cores.
Yes.
It sounds like both phones do much of the same thing.
You saw Windows Hello come to life for the first time.
No availability or price.
That is the power. Could primarily just be screen size.
Windows in your pocket. I mean, these phones really do.
5.7.
The 6-core versus the
8-core. Really do start to act like a PC. It's super powerful. So you know the products start at $549. They're available in November. Make sure you go and check them out for sure. Before I wrap up, one more note on
Lumia
and phones, and I'll wrap up phones for you. But before I do that, I want to mention a different product that we're also shipping this holiday. It's a different way to think. This is a Lumia
550. For the XL.
It's much more affordable phone. And if you just wanted to leap into this ecosystem, it's got a quad-core processor. It's full LTE. It's a great
lower
phone.
End, $139, 550.
And it's a pretty cool thing. What did you guys think of Lumia?
Available in December.
Cool.
They really need to kind of continue to make the low-end phones. That's the only opportunity they have for growth. They've kind of lost the flagship
market. So I'm guessing you
want
to talk about Surface.
Apple and to a lesser degree to Android. Yeah.
Come on, Panay, get a hat. 2015.
So an hour in, we're now finally to Surface.
So I've been working with the team very closely for quite some time, and a lot of you have been with us through the generations for sure. And in Surface, you know, we pour our souls into making tablets that can replace your laptop. That's what we've been doing. We had this goal, this dream. We just push, and we want to make you so much more. We want to make these the most productive devices on the planet. That's what we want. How do we do that? How are we going to do that? And we pushed, and now it's been amazing.
This would be a good opportunity to try the new Twitter moments.
What has happened with the transformation? This intersection that we talked about, this challenge between the tablet and the laptop, which do you buy? You remember that problem? It's gone. The momentum we see with Surface Pro 3 has just been so off the charts. It's so fun to watch the business grow, to watch people use it, to watch people adapt to it. To watch the product adapt to people.
The ways that people use it are just, they're so inspiring, I want to share them with you. There's a gentleman here today, his name is Bob Maletti, he runs his own company, and he's using Surface to
not,
do it. I
not
was
one
so
word
inspired by his story because it reminded
on,
me so much when he thinks about the
Twitter
design
moments
and the beauty of the product and the engineering and all that happens. Take a look at what Bob does with the Surface.
It is a trending.
I'm a big proponent of keeping things simple. And when we design machinery here, my goal is to have an operator walk up to it and understand immediately how the product is supposed to work. And then I see a product like the Surface Pro. You look at it and it's simplicity, but it's beautiful at the same time. When I get in the morning, I plug it into the docking station and it synchronizes. And so now I always have this confidence in not only having my data in two places, but I have one that's very portable for me. I was anxious to see how hard I could push it. So I pulled up the model of the machine that we're working on. There's about 1,000 parts.
You're watching our live coverage of Microsoft's devices event in New York City. We're about 1 hour in, and so far we have seen in order a demo of the hologram, the new Microsoft Band, and the Lumia 950 family. Getting ready to find out about Surface Pro 4.
I can open up Solid Edge. I can have emails coming in, just like, you know, a laptop. The Surface Pro 3, I'm just blown away at how effective it is as a tool that I can put in my one hand and be able to edit and actually do 3D CAD. You know,
he clearly
this
has
is
two
just
hands.
A breakthrough product.
What's the line? He's productive like a boss. I love that line.
Yeah. Yep.
It's cool, right?
He's productive
Thank
like
you,
a boss.
I got to tell you that. You look at that and it's inspiring, but it's not just Bob. It's not. Man, we have doctors right now picking up this product and connecting with their patients in ways they've never connected before. Never. We have composers writing symphonies with the pen that we provided that they're using. We have students taking the best notes on the planet, learning faster than they've ever learned before, and
the
loving
guy in the hat,
product.
Brian Roper.
Here's my favorite, because this was the
previous
dream.
Life, cruise
we have
ship singer.
Right
Perfect.
Now,
Seriously?
Yeah. And back
Perfect.
In Redmond, that use their Surface to make the next generation of Surface. It's super powerful. 98% of people using Surface Pro 3 right now recommend it to their friend and family. Just absorb that. Absorb it. Recommend to your friends
say
and
absorb
family
it?
The people
absorb
you
it.
Love and care about the most.
Not.
You're willing to recommend only the best things. 98%
For not to absorb it. Thank you.
Of people using a Surface Pro 3. This is everything.
This audience doesn't
to me,
look
this
very
is
absorbent.
Everything. It's not about the product. Now, what do you do?
It's about the awkward silences.
98% of people,
this man
they already love it. They're using
another
it.
Red Bull, quick.
The category is transforming. It's reinvented, as I've been told. We have competitors, you may have noticed. They're chasing it. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, acknowledgement that both Apple and Google have really basically made their own surfaces.
What do you do?
Yeah.
If you're me, if you're the team, what do? You double down?
You double down.
And bring the thunder? Or do you reinvent the category again? I'll tell you what we chose.
AC/DC, that's what we chose.
Yeah.
That's what I choose too, man. I've been thunderstruck.
Fingerprint sensor.
Oh, I'm glad the guys are getting a little extra dough. This might be enough to convert Jim Dalrymple to a Surface user. They got the buckling spring too, baby.
Pen attaches by a magnet to the side of the price.
Did you see that? 50% faster than a MacBook Air. They're taking them straight on.
Yeah.
Flappability, they still want to use that, huh? It looks like the pen is magnetic now. No more loop.
Yeah.
Surface Pro 4. I'm thunderstruck. But does it use AC or DC?
Both.
Really? This is the fourth generation. The fourth generation of building a tablet that can replace your laptop.
So they said sixth generation Intel. That's Skylake?
This product is thinner. Yeah. It is the thinnest, most powerful Core PC ever shipped. By far, nothing even close. The fit and finish on the product, it's exactly where you want it. Exactly where you want it.
Where's that?
There are subtleties in this product because we changed everything that you will never see. There are some that you will, but you will feel every part of this product when you pick it up. I promise you, you will feel it. Start with the screen. We went from 12 inches to 12.3 inches in the diagonal. Note, we didn't change the footprint at all of the device, at all. We did
a little bit bigger.
The bezels. We put the LCD gates into the panel itself. No one's ever done that before.
Somebody is the guy who did that, I think.
More real estate for Windows 10, for Office, for the power that you use it for. But the screen, oh my God, it'll knock you out. 267 PPI, 267.
People are doing the math. That's what's slowing
the applause. That's over 5 million pixels, just right there. 5 million pixels on the screen. When you look at this product, when you touch it, you will feel its depth. You will feel it. And the job of the screen, the job of the screen is make the content look real. Let the product fade to back.
Surfaces always have one of the best screens in the laptop space.
But I want to talk to you about a new technology in this product because it's so much more than just the pixels anymore. Pixels are awesome, and we all talk about it, and this screen will blow you away when you look at it. It's so much more than pixels. So stay with me for a minute. We're introducing something that puts touch, pen, softness on the eyes, perfect contrast, the pixels, the screen all together, and we're calling it Pixel Sense technology. I'm going to walk you through Pixel Sense so you get a feel for the technology.
Pixel Sense was the name of their
off,
big surface-like tablet. I mean, the big
perceptive pixel.
Well, that's one, and then Microsoft's the one that they originally
called
Pixel
Sense. Pixel
Sense,
cover glass,
yeah.
Well, they already
with
own
Gorilla
that.
Glass yeah. 4 on yep. it, ever shipped
and
on
move
a tablet.
Those around internally.
It's important. It's not the claim. It's important. Not just so we can say it. It's critical to understand
why. It's an example
why.
Of where Apple does a really good job of kind of showing what these
product.
Things are. Microsoft, their engineering background shows. They figure, well, you should know what that means.
On the planet, yeah. on a screen
you should,
right
you
now.
Should know what it means when we have
but it is
a,
the thinnest optical stack-up anyone can ship.
Thin optical stack-up. You should know that.
Yeah.
We also have our own custom chipset that brings it all together. I'm introducing to you today a chipset in this product called the G5 chipset brought to you by Microsoft. Let me explain to you what it does. In short,
it's the timing
it takes
chip.
That optical stack, and then it brings the best pen and touch experience you've ever witnessed or felt on any product and on this product right here. And I'll explain that. Let me introduce to you the latest Surface Pen.
As an eraser.
Real quick.
As an eraser on
1,024 levels of pressure.
Eraser.
That's
it has this beautiful stiction to it, so when you do erase
stiction.
From the back, isn't that funny? We finally put an eraser on it.
Microsoft Pen
kind of
has
funny.
An eraser, but the Apple Pencil does not.
It's weird. It's like backwards.
It looks a lot like the Apple Pencil, doesn't
Did
it?
Did you know
it
right does. Now, you don't know this, because only I know this, but I'm going to share it with you. 50% of people using Surface Pro 3, you know they use a pen? You know, when we started this, somebody actually walked into my office and said, hey, P, I don't know that we should ship a pen. I'm like, why? Because nobody writes anymore.
Hey, P.
You believe that?
Nobody writes anymore,
like, where
P.
are we gone? Nobody writes anymore.
I don't even have time to
That's
say your whole name.
The pen. We gave you 1,024 points of pressure on the tip of this pen. 1,024. So when you press down, and you know how that ink naturally flows out of your pen? It'll flow out of this pen, too.
All your battery
You'll
feel
life
that. Is
beautiful.
Good, too.
We give you a full year of battery life. There's two reasons for that. One.
Can you recharge it?
You know something about pens. Yeah, every now and then, if you use it a lot, you change the ink. That seems reasonable. That's the metaphor. We don't want a rechargeable solution for you because we don't want you to lose that that productivity moment. If you're in your flow, you don't want to stop. You don't want to worry. That's what this pen is for.
You know, that's brilliant because Apple's pencils awkwardly charges by sticking it at the bottom.
Yeah.
So now, here's the one thing on the product that I need to tell you about. That I still think about all the time.
It charges
when I
fast.
See you guys put
so the
on your
I guess
Surface
the theory
Pro 3s,
is.
You, I go, ugh.
But while it's charging, it looks
Look,
like a picket sign.
Yes. Yeah,
you know.
I know that sounds silly, but I wanted to show you what we're doing with this pen. Check this out.
Yeah, that's
so
smart.
Simple.
Yeah.
They haven't had a way of attach it, but then you had to buy a little plastic storage, loop.
But how it should work, it should be magnetic like that and recharge while it's there, just like Google's.
It doesn't need to recharge.
Storage, we created it for you. It's kind of it's right there, okay? Just wanted to share those for those of you who are
obviously you're not going
to
carry it around with it attached that way.
Because that's what this is all about, how you use the pen.
And I wouldn't call it stiction. I think it's something called magnetism.
Stiction has a bad connotation. You guys see that? Just a one click, and here's one note.
This is really weird.
Look how smooth the ink is coming out of my
I've always thought of the Surface almost as a OneNote device.
Can you guys see that? I want to make sure you can. Okay. And then I can just erase. You can see that easy erasing off the back. And it feels like an eraser, so that really brings it to life. And then at any given time, you guys have used this, you can double-click the pen. And if you double-click the pen, what happens is OneNote makes a decision, and this is that integration of Office and OneNote on this product. By the way, there isn't a product on the planet that runs Office and OneNote as good as this product. It's unreal.
I think that's...
Now I can take whatever I want off this screen. You see how I clipped that, and that came to life?
Response. People say, why are you doing all this stuff for the iPad?
But it
runs best on
it, and I can send this information to my kids or whoever I want.
Bill Gates has always been obsessed for 20, 25 years with the vision of being able to write and control your thing with a pen.
If I hold down my pen now,
Microsoft's tablets always had a stylus.
I have a tablet. How do I want to call her? How do I call Cortana? You just hold the pen. Watch down here in the corner.
Ah, nice.
There. Tell me about the Microsoft Store in Manhattan.
Click the pen to wake up Cortana.
Voice demo's always a bad idea on stage.
Came up, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, I'm not going to show you. There you go.
There it is, the search results, where all I do is hold the button, and I get back my search results. That seems pretty smart. But now I have Edge, and now I can write. This is the beauty of the product. So now, at any time, I can now write on the web the way I want to.
This is smart, because they're
so this is Edge,
using the Surface
here
to show off features of Windows 10.
What happens?
Which really, you know, need to be shown off.
Yeah.
Things like Cortana and the Edge annotation. Make the Surface be the reference product for that.
Yeah.
It's for others, and we're seeing developers be inspired right now. Traditional apps like Lightroom, Photoshop, Illustrator, all touch and pen enabled. Awesome. New apps like Drawboard, Bitwig, from guys out there that want to create things. Some beautiful things. My favorite, made by a gentleman by the name of David William Hearn, is StaffPad. If you haven't seen it, you should. Now, while you watch this video, let me explain to you what's happening with the G5
chip that I
inputted that we talked about. Watch how the ink
seamlessly
flows.
Oh, that's really cool.
Watch how natural his hand movement is.
That is fantastic.
If I recall the Apple demo, also.
Oh, look at that.
On the screen because of that thinnest
Beethoven would have loved this.
Look how smooth it is.
That's amazing. It takes those notes and turns them into notation. That's incredible.
Stop and look again.
Wow.
Watch how the product is starting to transform from ink.
Oh, every composer's going to want to watch this, I think.
This is the power that's coming through this product.
It's a product called StaffPad.
Watch how he's making things. He's changing things.
Wow, look at that.
He's creating with Surface. He's getting every bit he wants. But now look closer. What's really happening? David, out of his mind, down through his body, out of his arm, into his hand, and into your
yoga class.
Yeah. He just wrote a beautiful symphony just for you. That's what happened.
Very sweet. That is very sweet. I'm not a musician, but I imagine
it is so
that would be
inspiring
huge
to see what developers can do.
Love to hear what David Pogue
thinks. You
can
feel the content they're creating. That the productivity,
Pogue, of course,
the magic
Broadway
coming off these devices.
For years before he became a
now we're making it even more
guy.
Personal because this tool has become something so personal. We're introducing 5 colors of the Surface Pen. I hope you like them. I think they're beautiful. But even more important, we're introducing interchangeable pen tips. Why?
The employees seem to know why.
Simple. It's for you.
I know.
It's for you.
Oh, it's for me.
Are you a writer?
Yeah.
Are you a note taker?
Mm.
You sketch, you draw, you shade, pick a tip.
Pick
Feel
a tip.
They are magical. It changes everything.
You throw
it's
shade.
Like a ballpoint pen to a felt tip pen to even a pencil. Take a look.
Oh, that's interesting.
Phenomenal. Let's talk
about that's really interesting.
You guys got to hear about this, okay? Performance. People talk about Surface Pro 3 because of its performance. Yep, it's versatile. Yep, it's a tablet that can replace this laptop, but it is performant. So let's just measure it up.
There's that word, performant.
Surface Pro 4, 30% faster than Surface Pro 3. 30%. It's just power.
Can I hear you? 30%.
Now, I'm not going to compare it to any pad, I don't care what size, or any tablet.
That's the Intel Skylake number that, in fact, benchmarks did not demonstrate. So I'm curious if that's where they're getting
that. It is a great, great product. It is a great product.
Here's the shade throwing.
It's designed well. It works beautifully. But let's just compare it to give you a sense. Surface Pro 4.
On fleek.
50% faster than MacBook Air.
Mm.
50.
The Air, of course, not MacBook by any means the fastest product. MacBook out there.
Surface. Yep. Now, you asked for a terabyte of storage, you got it. We're putting a terabyte of storage in the product, you go pick it. You wanted 16 gigabytes of RAM? Yep, we did.
Up to 16 gigs RAM, up to terabyte SSD storage.
Terabyte, 16 gigs, 50% faster than our competitor, 30% faster than Surface. This is what you expected, right? It's what you get. Now, what do we compromise? Nothing.
It's surface mounted RAM, though, so you'll have to buy it the way you want it. There's no upgrading.
I'm not. It's unreal. We went from 9.1 millimeters to 8.4 millimeters.
That's
the only reason we stopped there was to make sure you had the full power of the USB 3.0 port. That's it. There's diminishing
returns
after that.
Doesn't sound like a good trade-off.
There is. But it feels so much better in your
hand.
You
can only get so thin. The connectors have to still.
There's 60% more pixels on this screen. We grew the screen. We gave you 30% more power. We grew the storage. We grew the memory. It's a thinner and lighter package. That's all true.
Battery life?
Nothing traded off. Nothing.
Battery life?
Now, let me show you how. Sometimes you want to use this at your desk, right? So let me just walk you over here. I want to introduce you to a new product. This is the Surface Pro docking station. Notice how I say Surface Pro. For those of you who have been asking, what about Surface Pro 3? Okay. This docking station, it works with Surface Pro 3.
Yay, we don't want to buy the Surface Pro 4.
But not a Type-C connector on the Surface.
It has two 4K displays out, so we're going to power those in just a minute so you can see the power of this docking station here.
At least that's what the rumors say.
Of course, it has four USB 3.0 connectors. It has a gigabit of Ethernet speed. It has everything you want in a dock, but it's just this little package here, this elegant solution. So nothing on your desk except for this. Let your wires go down somewhere else. You don't need the clutter. Now let me show you as I'm docked the power of this product. I'm going to click here on a Pro E.
Notice he's not using the
I might be getting punked here.
Keyboard.
Very funny. Very funny. There it is. Okay. This is a nice job, by the way, guys. That was pretty good. Okay. This is Surface Pro 4. And what I am using now is Pro E, if you will, or if you will, one of the engineering tools. Remember when I said earlier that the Surface team uses Surface to build the next Surface. This is the actual Surface database
4K display
that we use.
Port. Two
Let me explode
them.
The product out for you so you can get a better view of
That's
it
nice.
And move it down here. So can you see that? This is every part of the Surface. If I get the right
it's
angle, you can see how
GPU
all these components come together. Keep in mind, this now is rendering 400 unique custom parts that are built in Surface Pro 4. That's unique, not even Surface Pro 3. This is an entirely new product. It's got 2,000 parts in it altogether. And so you can see how complex something like this can be. But as I move it around so smoothly and so quickly, and as I zoom in, I can look at any component I want.
It doesn't
now,
seem
I want
smooth.
You to realize what's happening. I'm rendering millions of polygons right now,
jerky.
Right in front of you. That's what's happening. I know it's super dorky, but it's super powerful. So just kind of understand the performance there. Let me zoom out to give you that look
you
of the product again.
Like
you can
a boss.
See that. You guys feel that power.
I mean, this is the
cool,
opposite
right?
of smooth. See,
so
I was
that
like,
is the power.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the Surface docking station. I hope
if
you
recall,
love it.
The iPad
I want to introduce you to a
Pro
new
demo was perfectly
silky smooth.
Some of you have been asking for the new type cover. Let me just show it to you. This is the new Surface Pro type cover. This is the lightest, thinnest type cover we have ever shipped. The thing people say about type cover that they love is how light and thin it is and how sturdy it is. This product got lighter and thinner and more sturdy. But I want to talk about the key set. We've put in a Pro key set on this product. What you'll see is what we went from this tight key set design where we have now filled out the entire key set for your hands. Don't worry though, this product works perfectly with your Surface Pro 3. Perfectly. So if you have
That's
that
nice.
One, and I see a bunch of you using Pro 3, which by the way, like, you're super inspiring me right now. It's so fun. You can use this product. It's for you. But for Surface Pro 4 users who haven't used
it
yet,
so there's a compelling reason
on,
to keep the old Surface
the key set is beautiful.
Pogo
key
pins and
yeah.
power connectors, so you can use the dock and you can use the
it's,
keyboard
it,
on either
it really
the 3
is.
Or the
it's
4.
It's 19 millimeters right now between key sets. It's what we call the pitch. It feels so soft on your hands when you type. Best part, we then took the trackpad and made it 40% larger. That was a big deal. 40%.
Yeah, very important.
It feels beautiful.
40% larger
trackpad. It uses the full power of Windows 10 and really comes to life. What do you guys think of the new type cover? It's very cool.
This product,
when it clicks in together
mode.
And comes, it's just harmony. I mean, you know I love this. I hope you love it as much as I do. It's so beautiful. I want to switch gears on you really quick. You guys seen this kid before? Funny, huh? You seen it? I have no idea what he's doing, by the way. I just thought I'd put
Let's
the picture up to show you.
Let's see it. Oh, dear.
Yeah. Last night, met with the team that built the commercial.
Kid with
they
the face plant.
I don't want to explain it to you, but it is pretty cool. I want to
especially cool
what
at
the
widescreen cinerama.
So just a quick, just let me do that for just a minute. You guys have been with me with Anastasia for the last couple of years. You've seen her if you've been part of these events.
That's his baby.
And they're growing up and they're beautiful children. But I have four kids at home right now, and they are the light of my life. I will tell you, Windows Hello will transform the way your household works. Imagine how you can use one surface now to log in every member of the family and give them their unique content. Let me just show you a quick little video of my babies. This is Anastasia and Sophia. Check out how they're using Windows Hello for the first time.
Let's tell the world all the things. Hello is the special camera technology that allows you to identify using the camera instead of a fingerprint reader or a password. It does require hardware, specialized hardware.
Anna, let me do my homework, please.
It's almost like a Kinect camera. Kinect does a great job in the Xbox One of recognizing people.
Yeah.
These are the kinds of features, though, that some embrace, and then privacy advocates worry about cameras that are always on, always looking for you and recognizing you.
Yeah.
There's, of course, privacy concerns about Windows 10.
Yep.
I think the world's going to rapidly bifurcate between people who are willing to give up privacy for these features and those who say, I'm going to put tape over that thing.
Yeah.
But
do you want your kids really
out.
To be in a database
right,
somewhere?
Mapped in. Especially since Google and others have proved that,
this is for the Pro
you know, once you know what they look like at the age of four, you know what they look like
forever.
At 40.
We have the most amazing fingerprint experience to let you log in and out.
Oh, that's nice.
So the new Surface
so the two
Pro
forms of biometrics
comes with a fingerprint reader just for those
wow.
customers. Very cool. Now Surface Pro 4. When you think about algorithms written by the Windows team that guarantee enterprise-level face authentication, the work we've done for the front-facing camera on Surface Pro 4 is second to none. You get this product and you get the beauty of Windows Hello with it. It is a phenomenal experience.
Again, they're making
think?
Hardware
cool,
that
right?
shows off Windows 10 features.
Yeah.
And that's really, one of the big roles of Surface.
That's a Pixel
I'm holding the
mission
thinnest,
as well at Google.
Most powerful Surface.
And it's a good mission.
Yet, this is the tablet that can replace your laptop. I said it 18 months ago, and I will say it again. It will replace your laptop. It's replaced many of yours up there, and we are very proud of that.
You say this
I'm
is
so
the
so proud of you at home.
Camera
I'm
that
so
replaces
proud of that
your
team in Redmond. And for those of you watching, thank you for tuning into this.
Pre-order October 7th. Available October 26th.
You can pre-order pretty much right now. It's available October 26th. It's a great, great set of products out there and with a great array. Check it out. Now, worry about it. Now, you guys want to talk about another product?
Yeah, this might be the one more thing that Mary Jo Foley thought would be.
Yeah, I do too.
They still have Microsoft Surface
Sometimes
on the screen.
Sometimes I just walk off and don't, but this time I will, I promise.
Well, remember that there's the Surface and
Let's
the
just
Surface
sit and
Pro.
Think for a minute.
Yeah.
Surface is there. It's not RT, but it's they're less expensive.
I'd like to see a bigger screen version.
So this
but
isn't
you
the
wanted
one more
a
thing, because we knew there'd
surface.
Be a couple more. Oh, a laptop Surface.
Something with a bigger screen, something with the perfect typing experience of a laptop. And we've been thinking about this for years.
I've been thinking about it, too. I don't like the detachable
What if
keyboard.
We could do for laptops?
This is an acknowledgement.
Well,
not everybody
tablets.
Wants a tablet.
What if we could take all that energy, all that hard work, all that will, all that learning, and put it in a laptop?
I'd actually be more interested in that.
Yeah.
That's what we did.
I want a good keyboard.
That's what I'm about to show you. We made the ultimate laptop.
All right.
We made Surface Book.
Surface Book, Microsoft's first laptop computer.
Okay, look at the hinge. Oh. The hinge looks like some kind of robot.
It's interesting in light of the... Yeah, wow. What is that going to do? Is that going to go all the way around? Is that a convertible? It is. Keep going.
So instead of just a single hinge, it looked like there are like four hinges.
Kind of articulating.
Yeah. It has a chip, apparently.
This is something Microsoft avoided, I think, not wanting to piss off the OEMs, but they're full bore into this now.
Touchpad looks enormous.
They don't do it as a desktop. Who cares?
Yeah. Right.
I think they really have to do that.
Yeah, it sort of like rolls out the hinge. The key letters are lit up.
All right, that's
Microsoft Surface Book.
Two words.
This is Surface Book.
This is the one more thing nobody expected. This is nice. It's always good to have something the rumor mill did not predict.
Yep.
I haven't seen any rumors of this.
This is the ultimate laptop. It's the first laptop ever built by Microsoft, and it redefines everything. It redefines everything in what you expect in a laptop.
Dell's got to be going crazy.
13.5-inch diagonal straight across. It delivers 6 million pixels to your eye. 6 million. There is nothing close to
it. I wish they'd say the resolution.
Nothing.
Yeah.
267 DPI, and the depth of this screen is remarkable. I've been using it. It just blows me away. It has pixel sense, and exactly what we talked about before. It is so much more than just pixels. It brings that pen, that touch experience.
It has
David,
pen,
if you're here,
touch.
You want to write a symphony, my friend, write it on this.
You can still do it.
It will blow you away what this product can do.
I wonder if the hinge goes all the way around.
We pushed the tech to the thinnest Gorilla Glass possible, same as Pro 4. You look at a photo on this, it'll feel real. You watch a video on it, it will immerse you like nothing has immersed you before. But it can't just be about the screen on a product like this. It has to be about the typing experience. It is one of the most important things in delivering a great laptop. It is one of the things that those of you using laptops on your lap right now need most. I mean, outside of lapability, which you've all made fun of me for, but typing. The typing experience on this product is perfect. The make break is unbelievable. The sound. Guys, it's so quiet. You type and it's quiet, but it feels so powerful.
It's amazing.
The Tim Cook playbook.
Why are we whispering?
It's 1.6 millimeters of travel. We've been making keyboard switches for 25 years at Microsoft. 15 years ago, we brought you the ergonomic keyboard. We know what comfort is. We brought it all to the table.
We
know
what comfort
is. My favorite thing is the dish and the keys. Just slide your fingers in. It feels unreal. The trackpad, optimized by the Windows 10 engineering team to bring you precision, perfect tracking. It is made of glass. When you put your finger on it, it glides. It feels so lovely. It has 5 points of touch on it. It brings every Windows 10 feature to life in a huge way. Now, outside of typing and a beautiful screen, what do you expect from a laptop? Phenomenal performance. That's what you should expect.
Battery life. It's going to have good battery life.
This is a little bit different than Surface Pro 4.
He didn't mention battery
life
in the Surface Pro 4.
We wanted to bring you that ultimate performance. This is for the gamer who plays League of Legends.
Mm.
This is for the architect who's building a building right now or designing a bridge and needs to compile and press the system. It's for the scientist right now who's thinking about the cure to cancer.
For the architect, translation is going to be expensive.
As far as they can. It's for that coder.
Yeah, he's talking about
the latest
high-end
Visual Studio where they can compile using
what do you say, $1,200
at the same time and not lose
1500?
A minute.
What's the starting
price?
Yeah,
of
it's not
going to
be
12-hour battery life. Look at this. GDDR5.
We pushed these things.
12-hour battery life. GeForce. Oh, this
more
is a high-end
machine.
More important
than that, we've tuned this thing to perfect graphics performance. Let me explain how. We have the best engineers on the planet that understand a GPU for you to use. Our Xbox team is unreal.
Why not make a high-end? Why not make the best?
Yeah, right.
It's a demo. There's going to be other companies that are going to go away.
From which you can sell everything else.
One package and surface.
You want Windows to perform in its best environment.
You end up with Surface Book.
Yeah, I'm thinking $12.99. That would be an aggressive price.
That'd be a good price, yeah.
Pound for pound, this is the fastest 13-inch laptop ever made anywhere on any planet. This product.
$16.99? Maybe.
And with all that power, we give you a full 12 hours of battery life to use this product for. 12 hours. Let me tell you what 12 hours means to me. Use it for a week, I don't have to charge it. Because when I close it, I'm saving every bit of battery life with no drain. It's phenomenal work by the Surface engineers. When you open it, you're burning up to 12 hours. You can get to 12 hours. This is huge. You know what that means for you?
Yeah, like those three guys? I think you're right. I think $1,600.
It means you don't have to sit where you plug in your cord next time. It means you can get a Surface Book and sit up here, and you have to worry about the power. Because you get full power. It's what you need.
Remember, this is the first time they've ever made a laptop. So this, they're going to show off in every way.
Yeah.
Now, how does this compare? It's probably a good question to ask. We compared Surface Pro to the MacBook Air. I think that was fair. We're going to compare Surface Book and how it compares to a MacBook Pro.
Wow, they're really
by adding the discrete GPU,
not shy.
Two extra processors, it fundamentally makes Surface Book two times faster than the MacBook Pro. Two times faster. Wow. It just gives
it makes you
a sense
wonder why
of the
Microsoft
performance of the product.
Before.
But to give you a better sense, let me walk over here. Yeah. Do you remember that Surface dock we talked about earlier? Right here?
Works with that?
It works with your Surface Book.
That's
so it works for Pro 3, Pro 4, and the Surface Book. And we enable that with one cord plugging in, nothing else, and that's the Surface connector. See if I'm up there. I am. Great.
So I'm just going to love to sell all of these.
Now you're
going to
see the PCIe SSD performance in the product.
I wrote
which
a column in 2009 calling for Microsoft
status,
to do exactly
paying attention,
that.
Yeah, you go. Understand the kind of details in it. This is just a super fast drive. I'm going to grab what we have here is 3 gigabytes of gameplay, and I'm just going to pull it onto my screen.
Seven reasons
copy it
why
to
Microsoft
my desktop. You guys see how fast it copies.
Took
I just
five,
want you to
six
see that
years,
transfer.
Yeah,
this is 3 gigs
did.
Transferring full listened. Speed yeah. and just coming through and just like
speed.
That, it's on my desktop.
Nice.
Now I'm going to show you some gameplay here, and I want to tell you what you're seeing. It's not just a video. This is actually footage recorded off a Surface Book that was playing Gears of War.
You know, it's really what Microsoft's saying. So we give up. We're not going to appease the OEMs. We're not going to sit back. They haven't served us well, so we're just going to do it.
And they're absolutely right. You go into Best Buy and look at all the Windows PCs, and it's a bunch of junk.
Yep. The race to the bottom, crapware loaded.
Yep. Stickers.
You kind of see the performance. No glitches.
It's interesting to, again, with the gaming, because that's the most challenging thing you can do on it.
Because now we're getting into creator land. And I'm going to drop them right here into Premiere Pro. This is Adobe Premiere Pro. For those of you who know it,
our editors would love this.
GPU
and you're not getting one, effing
done.
And since
we're pushing the GPU in this product,
no effing way.
I'm going to show you what it can do from a performance standpoint. I'm going to take those videos.
Microsoft really throwing down the gauntlet to the OEMs.
Now what I'm doing is I'm actually editing a movie. This is where you think about what creators do with a product like this. You think what they want to get done.
I'm getting one.
You want to make a movie. You want to push this machine to do so.
This looks awesome.
Watch how I move these games kind of overlapping. This is what
this making
is
my,
content down
my
here
relatively
if you've
new Dell.
I'm going to play it real time so you can see the game.
Look pathetic.
Now watch here as I apply transitions. The reason I did that is I want you to kind of understand those
real-time
transitions
rendering.
Are also GPU intensive. So watch what I'm doing in making my own little movie here, where I'm going from Gears of War to the other first-party game called Gigantic, both played on the Surface Book. Did you see that transition, how smooth it is? For those of you who understand Premiere Pro, we didn't skip one frame, and we were in full GPU rendering.
Wow. So you're competing against a MacBook Pro that...
So you then ask, how do you do it? What are the tricks? How do you get such amazing performance and keep all that battery life? How do we make it so we can get rid of those cords as long as we possibly can? How do we do it with no extra weight? The product in its class is unbelievably light.
MacBook Pro 13 starts at $12.99.
It's craftsmanship. It's every detail.
I think you want to come in at $12.99. I don't know, though,
it's what
you can with a dedicated GPU.
Every single part starts as a billet and is machined to fit perfectly. down to the tens of microns.
It's higher res screen than the
MacBook
Pro.
So every Surface Book that we will build, it will be unique. It will have its own footprint. But it will be seamless. The lines will come off exactly how we intended them. There will be no gaps. It will feel fit. It's what you expect from so much performance.
I wonder who's making this for them.
I took you through this.
Or are they making themselves?
I took you through an elegant laptop anymore.
Right.
With an unbelievable typing experience, a beautiful screen.
This outperforms any competitor. The drop the microphone moment.
Class.
If they can get this under $1,299,
it's the first laptop from Microsoft.
Or even $1,299.
This is Surface Book. This is the ultimate laptop.
Okay. Do they need to get it down? Maybe not. Maybe they just say, look, it's the ultimate laptop. It's $1,599.
This product starts at $1,499. Available for pre-order. And it's available October 26th.
Available October. That's impressive that they kept this a secret for a device that's shipping this month. Very impressive. Apple couldn't have done that.
It's the ultimate laptop. But,
I think that's a good price.
I think it's a great price. That's an excellent price.
We got this whole thing, you know, and this is now devices.
Depends what you get for $1,499. Do you get the dedicated GPU? I mean, you must, I guess.
Satya pushes us to be growth hackers. Like, we can't just stop. Like, I lose sleep. Just a laptop? What?
They're going to have a PC?
Surface Pro 4. It was about bringing the thunder.
This is the one more thing.
This product is going back to reinventing categories. Take a look at this video one more time, just one more time. But this time, let's watch a little bit closer.
So we're going to see the same video again?
So yeah, as people are pointing out, the way that hinge works, there's no way you can flip it all the way around.
Yeah.
So that's just cosmetic, that hinge. But it's nice cosmetic.
Yeah. I mean, each hinge has a much narrower range of opening, but you need all of them to get it all the way back.
Right. Two USB 3 full-size SD card. I love it that it's a touch screen and it works with the pen. I think that's very interesting.
Yeah.
Boy, I wish it were convertible, though, flipped all the way around. 12-hour battery life significant. It's a dynamic fulcrum hinge.
What am I looking at?
You're looking at $1,499. What?
Okay, it removes.
What?
Comes
Holy cow,
keyboard.
It is a convertible. You can pull it right off.
And it has a pen.
Oh, my God. Now how much would you pay? Or is it... What? It's got a muscle wire lock. Oh, that was nice. Oh, it is a convertible. For those of you not watching this video, they just detached the screen, flipped it around.
Yeah, I love that when you think you've gotten the whole demo and then they give you a big reveal.
Yeah, it's getting a standing ovation from the employees in the audience. Now we can identify them.
Yeah.
They're scattered throughout the audience. They're saying, sit down, we now know who you are.
Yes.
The journalists, though, I think want to applaud. That is very impressive.
Okay, sorry. This is now the thinnest, most powerful PC ever created.
Sold. Sold.
It weighs only 1.6 pounds.
And of course, remember, Apple cannot do touch
on their
MacBooks.
Inch screen we talked about. It is 7.7 millimeters
thick. Big-looking tablet,
Don't worry,
but still.
Your USB ports, they're in the base. It's that same 3:2 aspect ratio you're familiar with. It is modeled and metaphored after an A4 piece of paper to give you that natural feel.
I think that's good.
It's a clipboard.
It's interesting. It's not a widescreen tablet. It's a 3:2.
You want to show somebody what's on it,
like
and you want,
Pixel,
that's what you use as a laptop. Yeah. And you want to turn it around? Is that what you
the
do?
The OEMs are just dying at this point. There's nothing they make.
It.
They can only compete
over,
on price at this point.
It feels so good when you touch it. When you're reading on the couch and you're looking at Flipboard, it's built for side-by-side magazine flipping. It's unreal, the reading experience. When you're reading
Aren't you
the
glad
web,
you got up this morning, folks?
that wow. people are writing, guessing what you're working on next, it's phenomenal for that, too. This product brings to life a whole new experience. You know what?
Notice the stylus, magnetized stylus, also clicks onto that.
I want to touch it. So I'm going to pull it
that
out.
That hinge makes it, as you can see there, just a little bit bigger at the end. But boy, you get the benefit, the fact that it can detach from that thing.
I know, I'm over time, whatever. Like, here's the deal. This is
look for Paul Thurrott. Hey, there, is that him? No, is that Daniel Rubino? Yeah, he leapt to his feet.
Is that cool? Do you know what you're holding?
This is so smart. He's waded out into the audience.
That's what you're holding right there.
And the journalists are all slavering.
Yeah. Pass it around, guys. Just pass it around.
Mary Jo and Paul in the crowd there.
I want to show you what else you can do with the product because it's important to understand the performance on it and the power of what's happening. The GPU is in the base. Can you guys sit down? Just pass it around. Yeah,
Microsoft
sorry.
Microsoft stock
the
going up.
They warned me that giving them out would cause ruckus. So the GPU is in the base of this product. So now I've plugged the product in here.
In fact, the stock price has been climbing throughout this announcement.
We call it draw mode.
When he says the base, you mean the keyboard? The GPU is in the key. So when you detach it, you don't have the GPU?
But now I have the full power of the GPU. Plugged into the top of the powerful PC that it is.
Interesting.
And now we're back to that full.
So it disconnects the GPU. That makes sense.
We talked
yeah,
about.
It makes sense.
It actually becomes a tablet.
If you're a creator,
when you plug it in, it actually becomes.
You know this.
This very interesting.
This is a 3D image on here, and I'm using Autodesk. And if I were to just work on this T-Rex, you see how I can, how quickly I can render.
So impressive.
Right here, I'm putting basically spikes on his back.
Using the new pen to.
How cool and how seamless that is. Let's just look, you know, dude, let's have some fun. And if you were to just put some scars on him and you're starting to make a real animated character
at
just
this point,
like this. I'm doing it with my
Apple
pen. I'm doing it with touch. When we talked about
worry.
This coming together,
this
is that pretty cool?
Product.
That's full GPU rendering right now in my hand with a pen.
And Apple made the decision, and I think are going to stick to the decision, not to put touch in there.
But the
Macintosh
real thing to understand is how we did it.
Yeah.
Products, but
how do you have a laptop?
I think people want
what
this.
What did the Surface team do? How did the engineering
that
team
explains
pull it
that
off?
Hinge. That's,
I'm going to show
that's
you the
amazing.
Hinge.
Yeah.
This here is what's known as a dynamic fulcrum. It's what we call it internally. It's total dork talk, but hold on. We did it purposefully. We wanted to be able to give you all that power in the top of the device. All that battery, all the energy you need to make it a full clipboard experience. If you're the architect, you get to walk around with it. If you're on a job site, you walk around
same
with it.
Same time as Microsoft stock's been going up, Apple stock has gone down.
Or a friend who's
more than
a coach,
a buck.
Or a friend who's this, and you're using it and writing, you get to use it as a clipboard.
Stock market likes
this. But when
this.
You plug it in, you need to be able to extend this base to be able to give the perfect balance for lappability in the product. Watch how the base extends itself. Check it out. See how long that got? Is that pretty cool? That is the hinge designed by my team out in Redmond. They are just phenomenal.
Very nice.
The work
very impressive.
Do. Now, how do we separate it? How do we get away from the clickety-clackety-clack and levers and this and that? And how do I get it off? It's so simple. We use a technology called MuscleWire, invented by Microsoft. And within the MuscleWire, basically, you throw a charge into it. It expands and contracts elegantly.
Wow.
And what it does is it locks in the screen or it doesn't. And so basically, when you want to remove the top, it's a full, by the way, it's a full laptop. You see, this is the whole point of it. I'm supposed to use it as a laptop.
He's
and
holding it by
twice.
The screen.
It is the
tossing
ultimate
it
laptop. But at any given time, if I want to, I just pull
that's
it off.
Amazing.
That's
just
it.
Press a button.
Yeah. Now,
so the hinge is not spring.
Quickly,
it is electrically released.
I can move with this device, and I can just plug it back in so simply, and it locks in, and it's just a laptop. That's all
incredible.
It is. And it comes together just like that. I've shown you something here.
Panos Panay knocking it out of the park today.
The most powerful laptop on the planet. It has touch. It has pen. It has more pixels than any screen in its class.
Lenovo and Dell and HP and Acer and Asus are all saying, oh.
Yeah. And it does this.
Crud.
Just like that.
Look at that. By the way, notice the Windows logo on the back. That's something they've never had before.
Yeah.
That's like the Apple on the back of the MacBook. They want to see, instead of all these MacBooks in the journalist row,
I just want you to feel the rhythm of the product.
They want to see that Windows logo lighting
up.
Thanks
for having me, guys.
Very nice. Very impressive. The one more thing, an entirely new laptop from Microsoft, Surface Book. They even took Apple's name.
There's a rhythm. You have to listen to hear it. It beats inside each and every one of us. It beats like a drum. It says get out there.
Starts at $14.99, pre-order,
special.
Just a couple of days.
Inspiration.
Arrives in stores 10/26. Actually, pre-order tomorrow.
Be bold.
Yeah.
Be an artist. Be tight with business.
I'll be in line.
make music.
Really going straight at Apple for the creatives.
Be a hero. Nurture that rhythm.
And you have to, at this point, say this is Satya Nadella's Microsoft has really shown that there was a path away from the Ballmer era, and this is it.
Yep.
Very impressive.
Introducing the ultimate laptop.
Yeah, this is the most successful announcement Microsoft has ever done that I've
absolutely
ever seen.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Here comes the CEO to take his victory lap.
Yeah.
Satya Nadella.
Thank you, Panos. It's fantastic to be in New York. Sitting backstage gave me an opportunity to see our work. I've seen it many times before, but it gave me this opportunity to see it with a fresh set of eyes and reflect. It's amazing to see the innovation and momentum with Windows. Holograms in your living room, a band that works with all your phones, but more importantly, frees you from phones. A phone that transcends screens, a tablet that can replace your laptop, even an all-new digital clipboard that turns into an ultimate laptop. We're making great progress towards our aspiration we shared in January, to move people from needing Windows to choosing Windows to loving Windows.
Huge. That's exactly right.
Yeah.
Since our launch in July, we've grown to 110 million active Windows devices. It's by far the fastest ramp we've had. Office, Bing, Xbox Live usage is up, visits to the Windows Store and the app acquisition is up, and more people are coming home to Windows. It's wonderful to see the enthusiasm for Windows, the new growth opportunities for the entire ecosystem. We now begin a new chapter of Windows 10 with new devices built for Windows 10 from us and our partners.
Yeah, well, I don't know about the partners.
We built Windows 10.
There's still plenty of room at the low end. There's workstations, there's desktops, computing. There's still some room for partners, but
what matters most
is
the mobility of your experience, not the mobility of any single device.
Microsoft certainly is showing the way here.
Because as devices come and go and evolve, you persist.
And you know, and they have to do this because if Windows devices aren't hot somewhere, they're not awesome in some way, then why even bother if you're an OEM?
Activity forever. The hub is you.
It's important, a vital Microsoft that people are excited about helps everybody.
Settings, apps need to be mobile with you. To whatever device makes the most sense at a given time, at a given place. This is what motivates us to build Windows 10 as a mobile, personal, trusted service spanning
Microsoft Store in New York City opens on
a unified
platform
for people, developers, and IT.
It's a good place to go. Stand
right across
in line
the street from the
Windows
Apple Store,
by
the way.
Major step forward in our ambition to create this more personal computing future. The innovation you saw today drives home the point of why we build devices. We build them to create and complete magical experiences. We think of ourselves in the experience business. We're not just building hardware for hardware's sake. To perfect the experience, we obsess about every choice that matters across silicon, the hardware system, the operating system, and even the applications that run on them. When we envision the opportunity to create a new category, we consider both new forms and new functions simultaneously. We plan to invent new personal computers and new personal computing. The introduction of the HoloLens is a great example of that. It's both a device that we are excited about, but it's a new paradigm for computing. We believe developers and commercial partners around the globe will reinvent gaming, communications, industrial design, architecture, education, healthcare, and much more. Similarly, our band is both a sensor platform and a cloud service that empowers you to achieve your health goals and connect you to what matters the most in your life. When it comes to phones, we're building the most productive phone on the planet. New office apps run beautifully on phones. Cortana personalizes the experience on your phone, but travels with you across your devices to help you get things done. Lumia 950 and 950 XL with Continuum are phones you can run your entire business on. And in developing markets, where phones can be your first or your only computing device, they give you both a phone and a PC-like experience in a single device. With Xbox, we're optimizing for the incredible experiences combining the power of console graphics and Xbox Live social gaming. With Windows 10, we're extending that gaming experience to the PC. The concept of building a new device for an application experience is best brought to life with Surface. Surface is built to perfect productivity. We, in fact, reason and build Office, Windows, Surface together from the ground up. This is how we are going to reinvent productivity. This is how we are reinventing productivity. With the new Surface Book, we're giving artists, musicians, architects incredible creative freedom that comes with the lightest digital clipboard. But it then becomes a full-powered laptop with a simple click. These are the types of new Windows devices and experiences that we believe people will love. I want to close by briefly talking about our mission. Every successful company has a soul, a unique sensibility that is the source of its inspiration and its creativity. Our mission at Microsoft is to empower every person and every organization on the planet to achieve more. Everything that is impactful and unique about Microsoft is captured and emanates from this mission. We make things that help you make things and make things happen. Whether it's writing a term paper, creating a new world in Minecraft, working to find a cure for cancer, or launching a new business, we approach our work every day with a mindset focused on learning about people's aspirations and how technology can help them realize their true potential. It means innovating in new areas, pushing those boundaries. It means partnering broadly. It means caring deeply about your success. This is what drove us to build the devices we launched today. We look forward to hearing what you think of these new devices and the experiences they empower. Thank you for coming, and thank you very, very much.
Satya Nadella, CEO, putting a cap on what is easily the most exciting Microsoft announcement ever. It's too difficult.
Easily.
Too challenging to even try.
Almost a company that's reinvented itself from the ashes. I'm so impressed by the overall vision of what they're planning here. As he said, the hub is you, and I think they're starting to put together a compelling story why you might want to go all Windows, just as Apple for years has pushed an all-Apple ecosystem. But Microsoft's a little bit more open about it, and I think very intriguing. You can still have an iPad, but you're going to want, as Nadella said some months ago, the best experience will be on Windows.
And the two biggest things about these demos, and of course they're the things that we have the least access to in terms of knowing how it actually works, are the HoloLens demo where they showed wearable holograms. That was amazing as a demo. Don't know what the reality is. Don't know when that's shipping. Don't know any of the details. But as a demo, that was
it's eye candy,
unbelievable.
But it was it was a great eye candy. And there they go again with it.
And the Microsoft Surface Book laptop looked really good too as a demo.
But also really important. Microsoft's always had a historical dominance in business and in productivity. But you see the fun being emphasized here.
Yeah.
They're not seeding gaming. They're not seeding entertainment. They want it all. And they say we have a compelling, even on the new laptop, a compelling argument for gamers. They're not giving the creatives Apple anymore. They say we want it all.
Yep. They went head-to-head on their comparisons with a couple of Apple products.
Didn't even bother to hide that.
No. And clearly, that's clearly the three big companies are going after the it's a high-end tablet as your main laptop, which is Microsoft with iPad Pro, Google with the Pixel C, and now Microsoft with this Surface Pro Surface Book.
So 2 hours, almost 1 hour and 52 minutes of a very tight, well-performed demo of some very significant products, kicking it off, of course, with the big number, 110 million Windows 10 activations, a number repeated several times throughout to emphasize that we are number one. And Windows 10 is doing very well, thank you. They were able to give us some good news about the universal app platform, saying Facebook's going to do universal apps. Instagram will be a universal app. That means it'll be on the phone. It also means it'll be on Xbox when the Windows 10 for Xbox comes out later this year. Big growth for Windows 10 in business as well, 8 million business PCs. They demoed, as you said, the HoloLens, but unfortunately it won't be available except to developers in Q1 2016 for $3,000, but they are taking applications.
They threw out some interesting new lines, new phrases for that. Project X-Ray, of course, was their project for the wearable hologram and the idea that you have this augmented reality. Now, everybody is aware of the fact that, and you know, there's some disappointment that when you use a HoloLens, the action, as it were, that is floating in space is in one place. And if you look all around, there's nothing going on. There's just a, but as they showed this demo, the person was all over the living room, running here, looking here, there, and the other place. And very, very impressive technology in terms of awareness about where the user is, what the user is doing, and being able to utilize the user's hands for a shield, for a virtual, you know, weapon in the hand and so on. Very, very cool demo.
It's interesting that they began with that before they actually even started talking about products, but I think that's the future, and they see that as the future, and it is a bit distant, but I think it's going to be an important future for Microsoft. Then they got to the Band, much improved, the second version of Microsoft Band, which was a surprise hit for them. In the first go-round, people actually really liked it.
Yeah.
They are adding Cortana. They're adding a GPS and a barometer. And they claim VO2 max measurement capability as well. And the price, very aggressive, $249, available for pre-order today and shipping October 30th.
Built-in GPS, UV monitoring, guided workout, sleep tracking. A barometer built-in. Very cool. And, of course, Cortana integration. And this is, you know, I think one of the things that they've got going is that they're not following down the cookie cutter, it's a round one or it's a square one approach that you know, most of the other major smartwatch users are doing. This is clearly in the fitness area, but it's a high-end fitness band.
And not to ignore the golf features, which I think are very interesting. Yes. They claim that it will know what you're doing, whether you're at a driving range or on the course, whether you're hitting with a putter or a driver, and it looked like they showed in the demo it could even map the course and perhaps show you the best club to use for your lay. That would be a big market just by itself. Then they got to the phones, and nothing new here. This is what we expected with the City Man and Talk Man. They're calling it the Lumia 950 family, and the implication is that in most features, these phones are the same. The differences are in screen size, 5.2 inches for the 950, 5.7 inches for the 950 XL. And it will have an 8-core processor in the XL, a 6-core processor in the 950, both with OLED liquid cooling, which I've never seen in a phone before. Yeah. A 20-megapixel camera with OIS, a triple LED flash. They're continuing to brand it PureView. The PureView experience, starting with the 808, has always been Nokia, and the Lumia is a really great selling point, a very strong camera offering, 4K video as well. They're smart. I think that's an important feature for that device. Yeah. It's tough, though. They're such a laggard in the Windows Phone arena that apps have not come along.
Yeah.
And I think their last best hope is that universal apps will bring things like Instagram to the Windows Phone in a more timely fashion.
And they emphasize Windows in your pocket for the phone. The phone is a little PC, and they emphasize that in part by with their dock, their Microsoft Display Dock, which has three USB ports and HDMI display port and so on, which enables you to throw to fill an entire large screen on your desk and use it as if it's a PC.
That's a really interesting application. They call this Continuum. It's partly powered by the fact that they're putting a full-bore Type-C connector on it using the US 3.1 spec, which means high-speed data in and high-speed charging as well, in and out. They're going to charge for the base unit, the 5.2-inch, $549, available in November, $649 for the larger of the two. But really, they seem to be very similar. So it's really more about, it looks like more about screen size. Both will support Continuum. And it's really an interesting idea to say, well, when you don't have a computer, use the phone.
Yeah, and I love that. I love that idea. It gives you flexibility. And, of course, they also tossed out the, and didn't talk much about it, but the Lumia 550 at $139 available in December.
Yeah, they got their growth has all been in smaller, low-cost phones in markets where the Apple iPhone hasn't dominated because of its price. So they're smart to keep those going. But it's important to do a flagship, I think. And and we've been waiting for more than a year for a new flagship phone in the family. And I think this is a worthy successor to the 1520. And
I
the
do,
930.
Too. If you want to have a successful platform overall, you have to have super fans. And the super fans will pay anything because they're super fans. And so you got to give them the device that enables them to go against the Samsung fans and the Apple fans and say, no, my phone's way better than yours.
Right.
Otherwise, you don't have a platform.
And frankly, you know, a lot of people, myself included, have wondered, why are they staying in phones? But that's exactly why. They need to have the full ecosystem available. Now let's get to Surface. This is big. The Surface Pro 4 is kind of a logical successor to the Surface Pro 3, Skylake this time. A little bit bigger screen, 30% faster.
Bigger screen, but the size of the device itself is not bigger.
Yeah, the bezels are smaller.
Exactly.
Yeah. 5-megapixel screen. They've always had great screens on the Surface, and this was another one. I think the big story on the new Surface Pro 4 is the new stylus.
Yeah.
1,024 points of pressure, an eraser, which Apple notably left off its pencil.
Of their pencil.
and then, of course, they brought that up in Brian Roper in his really fun presentation. Roper was on the phone, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
So it was Panos Panay showing this one off. Both high-energy presenters doing a great job, I thought, of engaging people. All your battery life, which means it has a replaceable battery.
Yep.
And somewhat improved, although it doesn't look like much improved, type keyboard.
With a fingerprint sensor built into the next to the...
That's a big deal, isn't it?
Yeah.
And the Hello camera in the for identification as well.
Yep.
8.4 millimeters thick, 16 gigabytes of RAM, up to 16 gigabytes of RAM, up to a terabyte of SSD storage. It's 4K support. Pre-orders tomorrow. Ships on 10/26. Again, that's when the Microsoft store in New York City, the new flagship store, opens. So,
yeah.
In fact, they say on the website there, lines will begin at 6 a.m. And $899 for the price. But I think the lines are most likely to be for the one more thing.
Yeah, right. That's right. The Surface Book laptop, Microsoft's first ever laptop.
Really remarkable. The first thing you notice is the hinge. And I think it's important that Microsoft, this is one of the, I think the flaws in the fact that the MacBook Air has so dominated the PC industry, everybody's making MacBook Air clones, and they don't look much different from MacBook Airs.
Right.
So this hinge does a couple of things. Of course, it's a little more flexible, but it also clearly establishes you're carrying a Windows laptop. And to make that even more obvious, and Microsoft has never had a laptop before, they've put the Windows logo, a mirrored version of the Windows logo, on the top. That's something they pretended to have when they did product placement and TV shows.
Yes.
But we've never seen a Microsoft laptop, so this is huge.
Yeah.
A 13.5-inch display, 267 pixels per inch. It's a 6-megapixel display, and I think that makes it the highest resolution display out there, certainly higher resolution than the MacBook Pro. And that's what Microsoft's targeting with this one, an all-magnesium body, 12 hours battery life, which is remarkable, and dedicated GeForce, NVIDIA GeForce GPU in there. They didn't say what model.
And the most interesting thing is that the GPU is in the keyboard. So when you remove it, you lose access to the GPU when you use it as a tablet.
That was really the one more thing, because Panos Panay did not even mention that you could remove it. He just said, let's watch the video, notice carefully, and of course, a bit of a gasp when they detached that screen.
And this is unlike the Google Pixel C. The Google Pixel C was innovative because it had a magnet, but this one has an actual thing that goes in and hooks it, so it's really on there solid. And to detach it, you actually have to press a button to release it. And so that's probably a good thing. You don't want it just coming off. And they were, of course, holding it by the screen to show how solidly it's connected when it is connected.
It's really kind of breathtaking. Microsoft was able to keep this completely quiet. Scott Hanselman, who's a Microsoft employee, tweeted, "Wow, I didn't expect that." Even Microsoft employees didn't know about this. And, of course, that's probably one of the reasons nobody else knew about it. A real shocker. PCIe for the SSD, that means a fast SSD. Pre-order tomorrow, availability 10/26. It's a 3x2 screen. I'm glad to see that instead of the widescreen. And that makes it, as a tablet, much more, I think, compelling and a little less weird looking.
And Panos Panay made an interesting claim. He said it's the fastest 13-inch tablet ever made on any planet.
Well, notice it says i7. They don't even put an i5 in there.
Yeah.
You're going to be getting the top-of-the-line processor. Starts at $1,499, but I have to presume that means it starts at $1,499 with an i7 and a GeForce dedicated GPU. Not sure about RAM or storage. So a really exciting lineup of new products from Microsoft. And I think when Satya Nadella... He said it's a couple of things that really position Microsoft and these new products. For one thing, I think he recognized that people used Windows for so long because they had to.
Yeah.
And he said this before. He wants to move Windows users from needing to use Windows to actively choosing Windows and ultimately to loving Windows.
Yes.
And that is as good a mission statement for the new Microsoft as you can think of.
I think. It's the perfect mission, actually, for them, because, of course, they've been... they've been able to brag for a long time. We have the biggest desktop operating system. Before Android came along, they could say we're the biggest operating system. But the retort to that was, yeah, but you have to use it. You know, nobody loves it. You know, of course they've always had their fans, but of course now they're really trying to win the hearts and minds of people out there, and they really want people to love what they do and to establish a kind of cool factor. And of course, people laugh at that, the idea of Microsoft having the cool factor. But come on, this is the company that makes Xbox.
Right.
You know?
So I'm looking at it. Ian Thompson of the Register has tweeted the slide from the demo unit of the Surface Book. It does look like there will be an i5 version as well as an i7, both Skylake processors, a 5-megapixel front-facing camera, 1080p HD camera. 3,000 by 2,000, which is really a remarkable resolution. Yeah, there's the slide. 10-point multi-touch, you'd expect that. I should have mentioned that. This is important. The Surface Book uses the pen and is, in fact, is the same as a Surface Pro in terms of its pen capabilities. 1024 levels of pressure. That's very exciting.
Yeah.
It'll run Windows 10 Pro out of the box. Let's see, the graphics is, it's interesting. So it'll be using the Intel i5 core graphics on the i5 version, the Iris 520, and you will have an optional NVIDIA GeForce graphics. It doesn't say which particular NVIDIA, but obviously a mobile part. Solid-state drive will range from 128 gigabytes to a terabyte, 8 gigs or 16 gigs of RAM, and up to 12 hours of battery life. So I guess for $14.99, you'll be getting an i5 motherboard graphics, 8 gigs of RAM, and 128-gig hard drive. You'll get the base model. I'm sure it'll easily go over $2,000 if you load the thing up. But still, you know, this is aimed at the high-end market, the market that's willing to pay top dollar for a top-of-the-line laptop. And it's a very impressive laptop. I think this is the new Microsoft. Nadella has really come into his own now. How long has he been CEO? More than, it's almost 2 years now, I would
think. Yeah, it's just been at least a year and more than a year and a half.
I feel like it was September of 2 years ago. But.
Yeah, so he's, but this is, you know, there was a long time where when they did something cool, it was like, well, did Ballmer put this in motion or is this Nadella? So I think now we can safely say everything we're seeing now is really got the Nadella footprint on.
He became a CEO in February of 2014, so it'll be 2 years February of this year. Absolutely showing the way. I think the board is probably at this point feeling like pretty good about the guy they chose to put in charge. You know, of course, Microsoft has always owned business. It's always owned services with Azure. And had a really strong offering there. But I think that they're showing they can also hit on all cylinders and become a consumer product company as well. Really, really impressive event for Microsoft. As I think we both agree, the best thing we've ever seen out of Microsoft. It kind of explains why the IFA event was so light in the details. They were working hard to get this one together.
I mean, you know, I've somebody who's a former Windows user.
You were an editor of Windows Magazine.
I was the editor of Windows Magazine. I was, you know, all in for a long time. The last few years, I've been iOS and Android, you know, in and out of Android. But this is the first Microsoft announcement where each and every product, like, well, I want that. I would use that phone.
Yep.
Yeah, I want that tablet. I definitely want the Surface Book.
Even the band is compelling against the Apple Watch.
I mean, it's great stuff.
And HoloLens, who wouldn't want that?
Exactly.
Yeah. No, I think Microsoft's firing all cylinders. This is very exciting. We're going to wrap this up because I know you have to get ready for tech news today.
Why not?
Mac Break Weekly coming up as well. And this Security Now tomorrow, we're going to let Paul Throt and Mary Jo Foley are going to be busy through most of the day. They are having a meetup. If you're in the New York City area, they're going to have a meetup, as usual, at Rattle and Hum. I think that begins at 4 p.m. Eastern time. If you want to head over there on Madison and the 5th. But if you want to hear more about this, they will be recovered, I think, and back in the saddle tomorrow morning, 11 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m. Eastern.
That's going to be the show to watch there's going to be a lot of noise about these announcements, and Mary Jo and Paul are really going to drill in and tell you what it really means with all the details.
Yeah, there's lots that I'd like to know. Who makes these, for instance? Yes. Where are they having them made? It looks like Microsoft's making it themselves, which is interesting. I'd love to know what the OEMs think about this, what Acer and Asus and Lenovo and HP and Dell. This is a little shot across their bow. Microsoft's never made a laptop.
I wouldn't, you know, I think the instinct is to think, well, they're going to hate it. But, you know, I think someone will hate it and someone will love it. I think the more visionary companies will love it because they've got to compete against Apple. And if the Windows platform doesn't have the halo effect that the iOS platform has, how can they compete? So this will hopefully give the Windows environment a halo effect so that when they go to sell their Windows 10 devices, it'll be like, okay, Windows 10 is cool again, right? Yes, okay, let's buy it.
Is Windows cool again? Is Microsoft cool again? That's the real question.
I think for a lot of people after this announcement, it is now officially cool again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting, they promoted the fact that this new laptop will do games, is a gaming laptop as well as a productivity laptop.
Yep.
You know, when I was watching it, I was saying, gosh, if only with the touch screen and the pen, if only you could flip that around and go all the way around with the hinge. And blown away when they popped it off. That's everything you want. Yeah. One device that does everything you could want to do with a mobile device.
Yep.
It's very compelling, very interesting product. And so impressive that Microsoft was able to keep that secret. Panos Panay even kind of joshed the journalist. He said, I wish you'd let us tell you some of this stuff instead of reporting everything ahead of time. Yeah. Well, he knew he had something in the back of his pocket there that might blow them all away. Nobody rumored this new laptop, and that's really exciting.
And I think also it has to be said that the Surface Book sets Microsoft up for bigger screen versions of that that are desktop. So you can imagine a 17-inch version, a 21-inch mm-hmm. version, and it would be running not the desktop version of Windows 10, but the mobile. Well, it would be run whichever one you want or whichever one makes sense. But the point is you would have essentially a touch display optimized for touch on your desktop. Everybody's been trying to do that for a long time. It doesn't quite work. But I think that's where we're headed, and this gives them a sort of line to build out that that idea.
Yeah. One of our viewers, Bawit Baba, in the chat room, says that he got the new Windows 10 Xbox dashboard update last night. He's in the preview program, so they're also getting ready with the new Xbox Windows 10 version. Really exciting. So we want to thank you all for joining us for this event. I wasn't sure if I should get out of bed. I thought, well, I think we already know everything Microsoft's going to announce. I am sure glad I was here.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mike Elgan, also for being here. He's going to get ready for tech news today and, of course, every Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m., 1 p.m. Eastern time, and 1700 UTC. You've got to tune in for your daily dose of tech news. And I'm sure that you're going to be rushing now to find somebody who was at that event and touched it and held it in their little hands. Pretty much every Windows reporter was there. That's why it was just me and Mike this morning. Right. They were all in the event. So thank you for joining us for this TWiT Live special, Microsoft's new devices. And it's going to be a very interesting end of the year for Microsoft. I'm Leo Laporte. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.